Hey, Fazellas. Looks like you guys are up to no good. Well, this gang used to be like that 2, 3, 4. So you think you're tough? Well, we hate rapping. But don't bust a cap'n, because here's what's happening. We're breaking out some old-fashioned tapping.
Hey, but the Crips, there's a new gang in town.
Oh, I've been shot!
We miscalculated. Retreat!
Quick, switch to Folly!
He's not gonna help!
Sky rockets in flight.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the theater. I am Dr. Tobias Funke.
If you're saying I play favorites, you're wrong. I love all my children equally.
I don't care for Joe.
Lindsay, take the wheel. Buster, find us a channel of the ocean.
Gee, I don't really have any mapping equipment with me.
You got $80,000 worth of cartography lessons. Get us a channel to the ocean.
Okay. Obviously, this blue part here is the land. And that would mean...
Oh, Buster,
we're all right. We cannot accept their conditions if we don't even know what their conditions are.
Do you want to read it?
No, it is thick. Why don't we just take it?
I could kiss you on the...
All right, well, was what?
The dogs found him almost instantly.
Free at last, dog.
I'm all right, gang.
I know my room.
I'm all right.
Oh, thank God.
Oh, what an adventure. Oh, my goodness. Buster, don't do that. What an adventure, gang. Oh, I thought that the homosexuals were pirates, but it turns out that most of them were actors in the local theater. You're right, though. It is amazing. I've been waiting for the universe to provide a path for me, and I think it has.
You're gay.
No, I'm not gay. No, Lindsay, how many times must we have this? No, I want to be an actor. Oh my God, we're having a fire sale. Oh, the burning, it burns me. Evacuate all the school children. Ah! Oh!
Say when.
Okay.
And suddenly, Michael recalled some non sequiturs from the night before.
So, tell me something personal about yourself.
Well, I have an irreversible case of ocular retinoblastoma.
Hey, I thought we said no more law talk.
I really can't see anybody right now.
Oh, well, I can't see anybody ever.
I need the flight records. Dad, I'm trying to find some money for the family.
There's always money in a banana stand. I am having a love affair with this ice cream sandwich. You want some?
Listen, take a bite. Please.
Come on.
The SEC has locked up our funds. These guys aren't messing around.
Don't touch it!
Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got some nature save.
Stop it! It's all wrong.
But we were just about to do the kiss.
Kiss, I know. It doesn't work. Look, you are playing adult. With fully... Pick that up, please. With fully formed libidos, not two young men playing grab ass in the shower.
Michael!
Mom, what are you doing here?
Oh, hello, Buster. Here's the candy bar.
No,
I'm withholding it.
These guys have been working too hard not to get paid.
I'll get on it. But until then, you know, I got Buster here to help. That's another guy.
Michael! Michael.
How'd you know I was here?
I called the office. You know, that kitty is starting to sound pretty damn sexy to me. Maybe I oughta...
That was Lindsay.
Anyway.
Yeah.
What's Bussy doing here?
Michael got me the job.
How'd you get him to do construction work? The guy's like the world's biggest chicken.
Not a chicken.
Please, don't leave us now, Buster. Please.
Please.
What are you doing? Are you trying to cry?
I'm sad.
You want balloons?
Speech. 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 Speech.
The family continued to chant, speech, 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 for no one in particular.
Speech. 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 Speech.
So, this is the magic trick, huh?
Illusion, Michael. Trick is something a whore does for money.
Or candy.
I'm running this company now, Dad, and I need the flight records, and I'm gonna get them, with or without your help.
All right.
No touching.
Come on, you douchebags, we're all on the same team.
Don't listen to him. He'll never stand up to the man. He's a chicken. A chicken.
Go. My whole life you've called me a chicken. But that's over now. I have nothing to prove. That is not how chicken sounds. Chickens don't clack!
Chickens don't clack! Sorry, I'm so late. I had another hearing. Here's the good news. I think I'm going to get off, huh? I have a good lawyer. You look great in red. Okay. Anywho, what are we doing here? What's the plan?
The plan? You're our lawyer.
It's a figure of speech. You're gonna be fine.
Oh, for God's sake, he's on his own for 2 days and he joins a gang.
These guys?
You know how much rejection I face every day? But in this business of show, you have to have the heart of an angel and the hide of an elephant.
But you've never actually had an audition.
Well, excuse me. Excuse me.
Some really great spousal support. You know something, Lindsay? You might want to start thinking about the example you're setting for your daughter, unless you want her to end up just like you.
Yeah, shoot me when that happens.
Is there a carbon monoxide leak in this house?
Wow, who won?
And for the first time, Job saw his brother as a man.
Let's get back to work, guys.
And Lindsay arrived.
Hey, is that Job?
It's an idiot on a scooter at night. It's gotta be Job.
Tobias was also having a bad day. Lindsay had met someone and he hadn't. And that's when he found what he thought was a support group for depressed men.
I guess his family's big enough, huh?
In fact, Michael's family had just gotten a little smaller.
Hello? Mom, you've got to stop starting conversations like that.
Something happened to Buster. He lost part of his body. I don't know which one.
The hands.
I'm going to war!
As an act of defiance to Lucille, he first went swimming in the ocean, where he was attacked by a loose seal.
If only your father was here. Oh, that George. God only knows where he is.
The car!
That's yours, Granny!
You couldn't handle it!
Are you the Bluths?
No, Dr. Wordsmith. How's my son?
He's going to be all right.
Oh,
thank God.
Finally, some good news
from this
guy.
There's no other way to take that.
That's a great attitude. I gotta tell you, if I was getting this news, I don't know that I'd take it this well.
But you said he was all right.
Yes, he's lost his left hand, so he's going to be all right.
You son of a bitch!
Okay, once more, from the bridge.
Because I have a brother,
lover,
daughter.
What is that noise?
Why didn't you tell me that?
How much clearer can I say? There's always money in the banana stand!
No touching!
And for the first time, Job had the game of catch with his father he'd been waiting for his whole life.
Okay, ready? Put your mitt up. There you go.
White power!
I'm white.
Buster was also mingling, but at Lucille's insistence, wasn't wearing his glasses.
Como estoy? Exciting night.
The C word.
You're not getting a boat.
One,
nope,
two,
not gonna do
three.
It.
Paper covers rock.
Fine, but rock sinks boat.
Michael.
Mom, I'm right in the middle of something. Get rid of the C word.
I'll leave when I'm good and ready.
You won't regret this, little justice. Okay, let's say from now on we call you David Ben Avram.
What are you doing to my guy here?
There's nothing. I'm just merely providing him with options. This yarmulke will protect you. David Ben Avram.
Hi!
Go to her. Ask for her hand.
Yeah. And maybe I'll get one from my brother while I'm at it.
Yeah. Get him out of here.
Hmm?
Get him out of here! Get the out of my room!
Oh my God!
So I believe it's a good plan.
The next day, Michael was ready to wow the board with his new business model.
As I told my brother, the president, if we start construction on a second model home, we can be cutting this ribbon within 2 months.
And I said, that's why you're no longer president. 2 weeks. Let's do it in 2 weeks. Hey!
Okay, we are just about ass to ankles back here, maybe. Do you want to hop on your cousin's lap there, please?
Whoa, bumpy road ahead. Hey, about dinner. I'd love to.
George Michael, meanwhile, had just been broken up with by his first girlfriend and was on his way home. Michael, for the first time, saw his father as a vulnerable human being.
Daddy horny, Michael.
Lucille could not contain her guilt any longer.
I didn't. I prayed that God take anything he wanted from us so that Buster wouldn't have to go to war.
Oh, Mom, after all these years, God's not going to take a call from you.
Anyway, it's a party, and I want the whole family there.
We're having a party?
No.
He needs to be the new face of this family. He's the only likable one in the bunch. No offense.
None taken.
I'm sorry, isn't Michael the least likable one in the family?
No. There are very few intelligent, attractive, and straight men in this town.
Well, that certainly leaves me out.
As it turns out, she had gotten up early and had taken pain medication because of a hangover-related headache. However, she mistook the drowsy eye alcohol warning for a winking eye alcohol suggestion. Fortunately, she had the good sense not to drive herself to the meeting.
No, I'll call for a car.
Unfortunately, this was after a failed attempt to do so.
Who the hell put...
Is there a way you call out my name?
Two, one, two, three, four, five,
six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 12.
Is that Joe?
He likes to make love to this.
I'd love for you to come with me when I cut the ribbon at the new house.
Oh, wow. Hey, can I bring Anne?
Who?
Anne. You know, she's the girl I'm kind of hanging out with.
I haven't met Anne.
Yes, you have.
Michael had met Anne.
Let her in. That's her right over there.
Oh, Anne. Yes. I know Anne. Hey, that's you. Anne. She's got a little hard-boiled egg going there.
Oh, it's so cute. She sometimes takes a little pack of mayonnaise, and she'll squirt in her mouth all over, and then she'll take an egg and kind of... she calls it a mayonnaise. Are you okay?
I don't feel so good.
You know, I kind of want to buy her a diamond.
Her?
Anne.
In an act of defiance, dramatically hurled the letter into the sea. This proved a more difficult dramatic gesture than he'd anticipated.
Tricia Thune for more.
An activist known as Johnny Bark has taken residence in this beloved tree and refuses to come down. What is he protesting? The expansion of high-cost, low-quality mini-mansions like this one here.
You gotta be kidding me.
Michael was out of options. And knowing that his father had a penchant for hiding valuable things in walls, considered one last desperate gambit.
This is crazy. What am I doing? Using a hammer to try to...
Are you crazy?
Are you blue?
Well, he didn't return when I lost my hand. But you not only embrace it, but I saw you kissing it while you thought I was sleeping.
Okay.
This stuff's kind of hot, isn't it? I hadn't noticed.
Hey, gang. Mind if I squeeze in here for a moment? Oh! Look at us. Who'd want to mess with any of us, huh?
Excuse me.
Yes. Oop.
Did you get a job or something?
No, I didn't. Unless you consider world's coolest daddy a job. If I have...
Any other questions?
Yes. How can you be even cuter in person than you are in your ads?
Are you a CEO, CFO, or other executive facing these or similar charges?
Why should you go to jail for a crime someone else noticed? You don't need double talk. You need blah, blah, blah.
Blah, blah, blah. No habla español.
Well, we're not here to talk nonsense to blah, blah, blah.
Can I get you anything else, ma'am?
No, thanks. I have to get back to rehab.
She's in rehab!
I'm mom, and I want to shoot down everything you say so I feel good about myself.
Look who's ragging on the old lady.
Hey.
Finally?
Because I'm an uptight... Buster! You old horny slut!
So what do you think, Barry?
I haven't read it. I had a really interesting date last night. A woman who actually works two jobs.
Can I tell you something, my man?
Sure, Franklin.
You are one cool Speaking of mothers, let me give that oatmeal some brown sugar.
You're my wife, you bastard!
Oh, man, what's the matter with
you? Okay.
Should we leave Justice here?
Yes, he'll be fine. I want your boy. Huh?
Justice, stay. Stay.
Describe this to me, Charity. Describe to me how beautiful the park is.
Oh, I wish you could see it. It's just beautiful. As an elderly couple, walking hand in hand.
We're having a wonderful time.
Yeah.
Already served, not to exceed 6 years, but no less than three. 3 years is what I give them, and then one of them dies, and the other one is not to die.
I can smell right through you, Jared. You're reading.
Release your dog!
You're the jerk.
Did I just wake you up? I didn't even know you were home.
No, Michael. I don't just sleep all day.
Actually, Lindsay was so upset at Michael that she tried meditating to calm herself, but ended up taking a 2-hour angry nap.
Yeah, this suitcase should be big enough.
He had become haunted by the loss, seeing reminders of the accident everywhere. It was the 14th inning, and tensions were running a little high.
I'll give you $1,000, you call the next one a strike. My knees are killing me.
No batter. No batter here. No batter. Strike three. No batter.
Strike three, my ass. Down in the yard. Down.
No batter.
We just had an amazing fundraiser for Hoop.
Hoop?
My anti-circumcision movement. I think it looks frightening when it's cut off. It's a Doberman. Let it have its ears.
Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm gonna go work in the banana stand.
And I'm gonna see if I can get a wrench to strip my nuts.
Huh. I need you. All right, I'll tell you what, Mom. You're always asking me to help you look after Buster. You can find somebody else. I hope she doesn't kill you.
I'll kill her first.
He's lying to me. Can you believe that? Where the hell is his family's morality?
I don't know. What? It's cold out here.
Your Honor, the purpose of a court of law is to find the truth, which is why witnesses swear on this. After all, they say justice is blind. Surely she has enough sight to catch the truth before it hits her in the face.
Objection!
Hey, guy. You tell me you're the actor who plays Marta's brother, Tio.
Como?
Oh, you're gonna be in a coma, right?
Unfortunately, the actor who played Tio had also starred in a Mexican film about the life of Oscar de la Hoya.
Joe, hey, you all right?
Where am I? Am I in two-thirds of a hospital room?
Yeah, listen,
George Sr. had snuck out of the attic and gone to a local Ford dealership.
Yeah, the Bronco's been discontinued. We're trying to shed that whole fugitive on the run thing. This is the escape.
What a fun name.
May I test drive?
Up yours, Granny!
You couldn't handle it!
You got a date?
Her name's Rita. She teaches children at a private school, and we're just having lunch.
Oh, lunch? Well, better bring some dog food, because all the girls you date are dogs, and dogs love dog food, right, Pop?
Shut up, you idiot. I'm trying to watch the game.
Just trying to make you laugh, Dad.
That's all I ever want.
Ryan Smith, the catcher. 3-4.
You know, Job, she's not a dog. It's just the opposite, actually. She's exquisitely beautiful. She's fun, carefree, smart, full of surprises.
Hello?
Lindsay. Hey, hi. Michael said not to call you, but I missed you so much.
You miss me?
What are you doing? Nothing. What are you doing?
Nothing.
Oh, hey, where's Papa?
Room 212.
And that's when Maybe decided that perhaps she could use her uncle to make her cousin jealous.
Excuse me if I was too busy on my knees in front of the toilet, Michael. I have a tremendous opportunity now that the Blue Man Group has dropped their cease and desist and invited me to audition in Las Vegas. Also, I've developed some issues with food.
I'm sorry to interrupt one more time. Is this the real Blue Man Group this time?
Tobias had recently been asked to address a group of depressed men who had been described over the phone as blue.
I feel like a idiot.
Listening in on my son. I'm a little worried about his girlfriend, Anne.
My advice? Get one of those teddy bears with the cameras in them. I had one in Buster's room to make sure he wasn't getting too serious with anyone. As it turned out, he got too serious with the teddy bear.
What do you say you and I take a little road trip down to Mexico tomorrow, right after Buster's party?
Oh, I can't. I'm meeting Anne.
Who?
Anne. Here, you took this picture of us in front of that bagel place before it was burned down.
I guess I thought she was with another family.
She's kind of my girlfriend.
Her?
Do you not like her?
I don't know her. You know, it's like you spend all your time with her. It's like you're hogging her. Like you're a little Ann hog, okay? Don't be such an Ann hog.
That night, Buster came home to an empty apartment.
So, it's off with Mother now.
In fact, Lucille was just giving Anyang and Maybe a ride.
You're trying to steal from the wrong man. Watch your back, my little immigrant friend. You're a wanted man. You cannot risk leaving the attic all the time.
Oh, when? When have I ever left the attic?
2 days ago. Right? Saw you floating around the Ford dealership.
Yeah, well, have you seen the new Ford Mustang? You can hump that hood.
Why don't you just stay out here and relax, pal, okay? Watch the softball game.
Okay.
I'll be right back.
George, we're never going to be out of each other's sight.
Which made this woman his warden.
Oh,
Dear God. Send me back to prison. You gotta send me back to prison.
More touching.
All right, fellas, look, I know you know nothing but a life on the street, but I'd like to offer you something that the Queen Mary gave me. The joy of the stage. So maybe you could start jetaying and stop terrorizing me.
6 minutes later, Michael dropped off his mother's housekeeper.
Mexico.
In fact, he was in Santa Ana, a town 6 minutes inland from his own. But the combination of losing his glasses and breathing carbon monoxide had impaired Buster's judgment.
Oh, this shall keep me safe from the hot Mexican sun.
Excuse me, what are you doing?
I'm trying to find a place to live.
Meanwhile, in the real Mexico, Michael had found the stair car.
Yep, there it is.
Chiclet? Chiclet?
You're the chiclet, not me.
Unfortunately, in Mexican culture, this was a much more inflammatory gesture.
Go, 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 go.
I have a very busy schedule right now.
My schedule, however, is as open as my relationship with my wife, so why don't we pair up? And hit the town together.
Oh.
I'll be your wingman. Even if it means me taking a chubby, I will suck it up.
Well, that's enough family stuff for today.
Uncle Job?
George Michael. You weren't followed, were you?
No, I don't think so.
All right, kid. Let's deal some drugs.
What are you doing?
Flashing the lights. So the dealer knows what's going down. Now we wait.
How long?
Who knows? An hour. Maybe five.
Drug delivery! You wanted some marijuana?
No, not me. My nephew did.
Show me the money.
Show us the pot.
I got it right here. Oh my God. Nice, right?
Okay, you can put your shirt down, Derek. Just give him the stuff. So, we have a deal.
We have a deal.
He's ruining his life!
Police officer,
free!
What are you guys doing?
We got your signal. You flashed the lights.
Got the drugs. You got the money?
No, we're all good.
We just want the money. You want to make this ugly?
We were just teaching the young fellow a lesson. We don't want any trouble with you, Governor.
Thanks very much.
You know who you're dealing with?
Drop the boxes. Put your hands in the air.
What is this?
No, we had nothing to do with this.
Shut us up!
No, these are just strippers. Look how hot they are.
Everybody take a breath.
I have to ask for an audition.
Do you have an audition yet?
Oh, no, I'm not in the group yet. No, I'm afraid I just blew myself.
There's gotta be a better way to say that.
Tobias rushed to the theater, hoping to be seen. Unfortunately, it was dusk, and he couldn't be seen.
What the hell was that?
And so, for the second time in 2 days, the family gathered at the hospital.
Everything's gonna be okay. I'm sure he's gonna be fine. I'm so sorry that this happened. I spoke to him just before he left the house.
Oh, really? What did he say? What was the last thing he said?
I just blew myself.
He said some wonderful things.
See you at the anniversary party.
Genghis having an anniversary party?
Seems that way.
Hey, is Franklin gonna be there?
See that, Mike? Kids love Franklin.
I just don't want him to point at my cracker ass in front of Anne.
Imagine what he'd say about her.
Excuse me, Mrs. Funke.
Oh, this guy again.
How is he, doctor?
It looks like he's dead.
Oh, my God.
Oh, little guy. The tears aren't coming. The tears just aren't coming.
Okay.
Just to be clear, it looks like he's dead or he is dead?
It just looks like he's dead. He's got, like, blue paint on him or something. But he's going to be fine.
What is wrong with you?
This doctor!
I'll let you celebrate privately.
Hey, we want this pumped!
Michael would have walked away forever, but he was struck by something he remembered from his childhood.
You know...
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the flight of the...
Job charged at Michael with the scissors, but Michael, as he always did, picked rock.
You wanted to make me look foolish.
Put him foolish with scissors!
Which beat scissors. Unfortunately, the whole incident was covered by the paper.
Nobody looks good in this.
Especially that little dude.
That's Anne.
Who's...
It doesn't matter.
You stay on top of her, buddy. Do not be afraid to ride her. Hard.
Lindsay almost stumbles upon a dating opportunity.
You look really hot.
But instead is admitted to the hospital with a fever of 104.
Beep, beep, beep. That's one of my partners. Excuse me.
I would like to be one of your partners. Do you think he got that, the two meanings?
He's running pretty fast. I think he did.
George Michael, I don't think you should be going on this promised land thing.
What? Why, is this because I missed school?
No.
You didn't miss school for that?
And that's when Maybe decided to become a devout Christian.
Do you guys know where I could get one of those gold necklaces with a T on it?
That's a cross.
A cross from where?
That night, Lindsay headed to the club to try again to meet someone.
Two weeks to build a house. Doesn't have to be good, just has to look good.
I just want my kids back.
And so the guys went to work. Things didn't go smoothly at first. Buster looked for ways to hurt himself.
Love and honor your spirit and flesh. First, the flesh. I will caress and tweak. I will nibble and bite. I will blow alternatingly hot and cool.
Oh, man, I can't wait to get married.
You were scared.
What are you talking about?
Go, 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 go.
Come on. You gonna get off and do your little dance, too?
No, I hurt my ankle yesterday shooting hoops or something.
Go, 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 go! Oh, God, my ankle.
Oh, don't move.
Let me hold it.
They're making promises to each other. It's all that fidelity and pledging yourself to a woman garbage. You know, I wine them and dine them, but I don't let them tell me what to do. I don't let them tell me what to do.
Hey, I'm the president now.
Filling Dad's shoes, literally.
Except their shoes don't fit.
But I did finally get into Dad's pants. Although I had to have the crotch taken a little bit.
You know, Joe, maybe it's the suits, but I think you may be beginning to alienate some of the employees down at work.
What? Oh, that's great. The president has to worry about alienating the employees now.
In fact, Job had started to alienate some of his colleagues.
Worst that can happen is I can spill some on my $3,000 suit. Come on!
Hey.
Yeah, the guy in the $4,000 suit is holding the elevator, but the guy doesn't make that in 3 months. Come on! Why don't I just take a whiz through this $5,000 suit? Come on!
Neither one of us wants to get divorced. And secondly, I know you're the big marriage expert. Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot. Your wife is dead.
Well, let him see he's not the only one who builds solid houses, you know? I think you'll be pretty impressed, knock on wood.
In fact, Michael was meeting at home at the behest of his fugitive father.
I have been a part of this archaeological dig. I think we found a part of a pterodactyl under Fashion Island.
Careful. Oh. That was 90% gravity.
There's my little girl. I've got great news. Daddy has the entire day off.
But you have every day off. You don't have a job.
Well, I don't need money to hang out with my daughter. Where are you going?
We're going shopping.
Oh, no, I can't do that.
I'd love to meet your family.
Michael knew from experience that this would not turn out well.
Usually once or twice a week, we get it.
If you like the small, why don't you come back for the medium?
See an auto-view shield. Right, you can see that, right? I probably should warn you about my mother.
Tobias had attempted an entrance that he hoped would enchant his daughter.
Magical image!
Oh! Read me the appetizers again.
Fried cheese.
with club sauce. Popcorn shrimp with club sauce. Chicken fingers.
Oh, stop it, you're making me dizzy.
With spicy club sauce.
No, I mean stop it.
Joe?
So I got a call today from Gene Parmesan, our private eye. He said he found something big.
We have a private eye, huh?
Oh, I hired him 100 years ago to find out if your father was cheating on me. He never did find anything.
Well, he can't be very good then. What did he find?
He said he wanted to tell us in person.
Don't get up. I just finding the supplies because I'm a private detective. Gene Parmesan, how are you doing?
Ah, Gene! Oh, Gene, isn't he the best?
Gene was far from the best.
Very impressive.
Listen, I have a construction job for you. And if you clean yourself up, who knows? You might actually get a date out of this. Okay.
See ya.
I'm George Sr. Ooh, that's good. That's the voice. I've got the voice.
That's not my voice.
Oh my God! What are you doing here?
I'm having a f***ing tea party. What does it look like? I live here. You tell anybody, you are dead.
Tobias saw the raw power of George Sr.
Stop licking my hand, you horse's ass.
And the next morning, Michael ran into his son doing something suspicious.
Morning.
Hi.
Where are you going with that food?
I was just gonna eat some of my grandfather's favorite foods in my room. It's the form that my grief is taking.
I think George Michael's hiding Anne in the attic.
From who, the Nazis?
No.
I'm gonna build an airport. Put my name on it.
Why, Michael? So you can fly away from your feelings.
You can keep them bottled up, but they will come out, Michael. Sometimes in the most unexpected... Hey, where the f*** are my hard-boiled eggs?
Blah blah is a handsome professional man, and I'm only used to, well, none of those things.
Okay, Lindsay, are you forgetting that I was a professional twice over, an analyst and a therapist, the world's first analrapist?
Yes, and you were almost arrested for those business cards.
Yes, no, it did not look good on paper.
Take off your glasses. Oh. Wait, wait. Let down your hair. No, glasses on, hair back up. Now, let's just get that hair right back up.
Do you want me to turn the lights off? What about that?
Yes, yes, please.
How's that? Is that better?
It just seems like there's still light coming in from under the door.
And Maggie did buy the fat suit to serve as her pregnancy belt.
All right, this is going back.
But soon upgraded to a higher quality latex model.
It's time!
You know I would never date anyone without you being okay with it, right?
Yeah, and you don't have to do that.
Great, because I didn't do it this time. I kind of reconnected with that blind prosecutor I used to date, Maggie Leiser.
Her?
Justice cannot be blind, Doc. He's got a handle and everything. Come on, boy. You know, Mom, we have no idea where Dad is. How's he gonna hear about the party?
Why do you have the baby monitor out?
She wants her man back.
Yo, man, you're gonna get your sorry white ass thrown in jail. I said that's enough.
Hearing that he isn't homeless is good enough for her.
Buy me a drink?
You're really sweet, but no. I'm Tom Jane.
And Lindsay, crushed and alone, for the first time, misses her husband.
Well, Tobias. So
Lindsay.
Is that George Michael's diamond cream?
Oh, yes. Well, I ran out of blue and I couldn't find anything else. I think my nipples are bleeding.
Come on, let me play Cupid this year.
Oh, I thought he went already.
Yeah, I'm giving you mine.
Oh, because you're too afraid to ask Sally Sitwell to go with you.
That's not true. That's not true at all.
Chicha.
What is that? Is that a chicken?
What's this?
Oh, Michael's scared to ask out Sally.
No, I'm not.
This is priceless.
These aren't even birds. Do you run at all?
Oh, yes. I was in the Olympics once. I won a silver medal.
Now I'm very embarrassed to be out of breath in front of you. But you take my breath away.
Oh, Michael. You're such a...
I'm not going anywhere. All your water's doing is whetting my appetite for protest. No hair for oil! No hair for oil!
Fine, we'll drown you out with music.
Crank it up! I'm in the mood to dance.
Now there's someone who could have used a good mother.
Whore!
There was a message. It was about my health, but it doesn't matter. My son and I...
Buster, what are you doing with mother's rape horn? Yes, I have a rape horn, Michael. Because you took away my mace.
Yeah, like anyone would want to R her.
Lindsay and Tobias were back with the arbitrator.
As you know, it is very difficult to establish fault in a divorce. But one indicator is fidelity. Now, my client has not pursued sex outside of this marriage.
Nor in it.
I got this one.
Upstairs, Job was preparing to set up the accountant under his father's helpful gaze.
Well, who called the cops?
And with the aid of some helpful gaze.
You told me to hire people who look like my friends.
Hey, you got the blood, right?
Yeah, I got two buckets full, right? Hey, what the hell happened to the blood?
Hey, brother.
Whoa, somebody put on his lipstick in the car.
I love juice.
This went really well, huh? Maybe sometime we can have dinner?
Could I see your house?
Michael was caught off guard by the question.
No, I can't do that.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
And he vowed not to be caught off guard again.
Well, I didn't mean to...
Here you go, hot tea. Because that's what you are. A hot tea.
Stop me from pouring this on myself. I can't take this anymore.
All right, now listen, Oscar. Maybe you should think about moving on, you know? I mean, this really isn't your scene, with the sweaters and the furniture, and maybe you should take a leap at freedom, like my father. Just run. Is that her rape horn?
It's more like a starter's pistol.
Meanwhile, Tobias set about learning how to operate his new cell phone.
Oh.
Look at her. Look at her down there. Does she look sad to you?
Oh, my God. That's Anne.
Who?
It's the girl who ripped my heart out. The girl whose face will always be etched in my mind.
Huh?
She's really funny.
Well, let's hope so.
Don't forget the chicken wing.
Do not ask me how I did it. They offered us a plea bargain.
Really? There's a chance we don't have to go to trial.
Absolutely. And I say we take it because we will never get an offer this good again.
Wow.
Great. What's the offer?
Well, I didn't read it. Well, I just got it yesterday. FYI, I'm trying to get back into the dating world.
You're not one of those silly men that's dressed like a woman, are you?
No, baby, I'm the real thing.
Glasses off. Glasses on. Hair up. Glasses off. Down on. Have we done up off?
Oh, Jill, this is so wrong.
And bright. Wrong and bright.
I don't really deserve a medal or a party.
No, you deserve this. Here, take my business card. No, it's pronounced a nowripist.
It wasn't really the pronunciation that bothered me.
You see, Buster, it wasn't the seal that you couldn't stand up to. It was Lucille. Oh, I'm getting chills. If this was a Lifetime Moment of Truth movie, this would be our act break.
But it wasn't. Job had done $45,000 in damage.
In there, please.
Hey, where's my desk?
Oh, I think it's the massage table in the break room now. Take the window.
No, hold it. Job, Mom may think that she's given you my job, but the board still has to approve that decision.
Actually, they already have.
Why should we believe in you?
For the same reason you should believe that a $100 bill is no more than 100 pennies.
I'll go to your party and then I'll go to Mexico. I guess that'll be my quality time with my son.
Mexico?
Yeah, Mom's PI found the stair car down there.
Jean Parmesan?
Right here.
He's doing that for us? And on the night of his date with Rita.
who he didn't want to bring over here. Probably because, let's face it, you people haven't been great with the others.
Well, in our defense, Mom, we're not exactly dog people.
We have got to start being nicer.
I'm starting right now. Buster, the party's not for you anymore.
Oh, okay.
It's a welcome Rita party.
I know where she works. We can pick her up and surprise her.
You're so right. This is better than a party for me.
Oh, come on, grow a pair.
I was almost attacked last night in my own home. I walk in and there's a colored man in my kitchen.
Colored? What color was he exactly?
Blue.
Hello, Lucio. Oh.
George Sr. was in the church, where he was mourned by his longtime assistant and accomplice to his escape, Kitty, as only a few days earlier, he'd been declared dead.
Michael, this is a close-up satellite photograph of the Iraqi countryside. See this little series of hills around that stream? Those are bunkers. We believe that those bunkers contain weapons of mass destruction.
That's it. I don't want, you can't, I don't, please, you gotta stop coming here.
It is obvious I'm not wearing a bra, right?
I can't take this anymore. I am, I'm paying far too big a price for this.
Well, what about me? I mean, this is the third time I've come here. I haven't even been remotely harassed.
That is not what I'm paying for.
Have I lost it? Did I ever even have it?
I'm paying thousands of dollars in Krugerrands.
What?
Gold Krugerrands. Your mother snuck them in here, stuffed in energy bar wrappers to keep me from getting strangled in the shower, or worse.
Stabbed?
In a way. I used them to pay off the other guys, to stop them from hollering obscenities at my little girl. But you keep coming back here, honey, and I'm going broke.
That's all I've ever wanted from you, Daddy. For you to spend money on me.
Close it. You look like the window of a butcher shop.
Thank God I can finally get rid of him.
I'll see you in 5, Mom.
We've obtained photographs that officials call definite proof of WMDs in Iraq. What that means for your weekend, I tell.
It seems that due to the new information sharing provisions in the Patriot Act, the photos had made the rounds through several branches of government.
When we started talking to you, we didn't have anything. But now, we got something. And you're gonna do time for it.
Those are the pictures?
They're all over the news.
Those are balls.
What?
Barry was right.
Yeah.
Tobias had inadvertently photographed himself while learning to use his camera phone.
See, this close, they always look like landscape. Nope. You're looking at balls.
Soon, forensic scientists confirmed this. And for the second time in 2 days, the information sharing network put into place by the Patriot Act was put to use.
They're balls.
We're looking at balls. Let's turn it around.
Copy on the balls. We're turning.
Stop her!
Stop yelling at me!
I'm leaving!
And that's when Buster noticed the seal on Rita's backpack.
Hey, talk about cathartic. Now that's an act break.
What happened to you?
What? Oh, my ears. The doctor said I can't go to sleep for 5 hours. Or I might die or something. Oh, I got blown. So I can't sleep.
Fucking $6,300 suit. Come on.
Hi there.
What's she doing here?
Merry Christmas to you too, Uncle Job.
Everything all right?
Just don't want people's kids getting their sticky little fingers all over these $2,600 pants.
Oh, yeah, you think they're gonna go right for the pants, do you?
Okay, come on. Okay. So should.
Well, do it your way. I'm just here to have fun.
Not too much fun, all right? I already gave my big sexual harassment speech today.
And please refrain from discussing or engaging in any sort of inter-office or finger or testing or being or even though so many people in this office are begging for it.
And if anybody does anything with my sister Lindsay, I'll take off my pants, I'll shave, and I'll personally.
Let's get this going.
What are you talking about now? You're not gonna let these people go home and change your clothes?
I don't think we need people trying to compete with what I'm wearing.
Which one is Michael? Swoop me!
I really appreciate you coming over, Uncle Jack.
Thank you for having me. You may be amazed. I'm invited into very few personal homes. To the nuts!
It's okay, she's alive.
And soft.
Soft and alive.
All right, let's not add that to the charges.
Oh, don't tell me you won't open it on ethical grounds.
I'm not sure what I'm gonna do.
What is with the insane moral code in this family?
Yes, we did it. We're getting rid of the Ten Commandments.
Job had recently made a recording of his ventriloquism act.
Franklin comes alive.
He hoped it would break down racial barriers and maybe be a crossover hit.
It ain't easy being white. It ain't easy being brown. All this pressure to be bright. I got children all over town. Sometimes, hey, where'd the guy go?
It takes a little courage, Michael. I know that's not your strongest suit. You're even scared to ask a girl out on a date.
Why does everybody think that I'm scared of girls?
Because you're a chicken.
Chicken. Cuckoo ka-cha! Cuckoo ka-cha!
What are you doing?
Michael and women? A
cuckoo-cha!
That's what I was just telling
him.
Look, I haven't found the right girl. When I do, I will ask her out. Has anyone in this family ever even seen a chicken?
Wait, I got the perfect date!
That's enough. Lindsay, didn't want to tell you earlier, but I did get you a car.
Is it the Lexus?
It's more like a Lincoln.
Oh, come on! Here you go, hot dog. Take the pill.
What's a forget-me-now?
They're pills that create a sort of temporary forgettiness. So if somebody finds out how you do a trick, you just give them one of these and they forget the whole thing. It's a mainstay of the magician's toolkit. Like how clowns always have a rag soaked in ether.
Joe, this is flunitrazepam. It's a roofie.
Those are illegal.
Shut up, Mom. Don't let me give you another one of these.
Power through and keep our heads down, you know. We might be able to...
Anyang and I are fine here. I mean, you don't have to worry...
Anyang.
You don't have to worry so much. I mean, obviously, your dad doesn't want to spend time with you, but, you know, go to the beach or whatever.
He's just not around, okay?
He no have father? Or the lady adopt him too?
No, he have father. Father no love him.
No, he love me. Loves me. He loves me. So, all right, maybe I will take a little time off and go to the beach or something.
I went to the beach once. Next thing I know, I'm in crate next to pig.
I will go.
It was a secret she hoped to keep.
Oscar will be heard.
And he didn't.
That's what makes it so hot.
I heard zoo noises.
It's nothing. Go back to bed.
So, everybody's still up, huh?
I'm gonna lie down for a little bit, but just, I can't fall.
Hey, how would you like to come to the party with me today?
And Oscar was giving Lucille a little afternoon delight.
These are really delicious.
I'll get some more. Where did she go?
But you got some beta waiting and I think I'm much.
That's my wife and my nephew. We have an open relationship.
Just then, Lucille arrived, craving a frozen banana. And the effects of Lindsay and George Michael's afternoon delight was overshadowed by the effects of Oscar and Lucille's afternoon delight.
Tobias, watch out.
Tobias couldn't hear and didn't manage to get out of the way in time.
What the hell was that?
Mom and Dad clearly were trying to keep this hidden from us.
But this could be anybody. This could be a deformed neighbor or...
A child that Mom and Dad gave up for some reason and whose identity they're now using to pin their crimes on. You know, the prosecutor said that there was that account with money in it labeled Ann Bluth. Her name is Nellie.
Michael, do you remember when you thought there was a mysterious Mr. F out to get you?
Mr. F.
Yeah, but that was retarded. Misguided. This is different. This is Ann Bluth.
Different.
Well, why don't you just go to Dad and ask who Nellie is, point blank?
So he can just cover it up and lie? I can't stand to hear one more lie out of this family.
Oh, there's the woman I'm sexually attracted to.
Okay, but that's the last one.
Well, I'm off to the gym to prepare for our tryst.
Tryst?
Yes, Lindsay and I are planning a night of heterosexual intercourse.
You can just say intercourse.
We talked about it last night.
After a disappointing attempt at lovemaking.
This isn't going to happen. I just want you to be satisfied.
Oh, T, you're always thinking of others.
I tried that. It didn't work either.
Well, you know, maybe I would be more attracted to you if you're in better shape. You know, if you're just more muscular, masculine, does that make me shallow?
No. I was going to say the same thing to you.
Buster and Job find themselves closer than ever.
And there you are. We've removed the hook and there's been no damage.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah, he's going to be fine. But unfortunately, you've still got a hook in your ass.
I'll go unpack.
Here's some money. Go see a Star Wars. Who is it?
Your son.
What?
I was looking for Buster.
He's not here.
Well, what are you doing? And do you want to go out? Or...
Why are you trying to get me out of the house?
I just thought that we could hang out.
Lucille was suspicious that Job was up to some sort of power grab.
Jean Parmesan, Lucille Bluth. My son is trying to get me out of my house. I think he may be up to something. Oh, hold on. That's probably him. Jean? It's just some idiot with balloons.
Oh, is it?
Ah, I knew it!
Hi.
And her. Too good for us? Buster, you should have finished the job.
Job? What job?
Did I say job? I meant Joe.
Buster's the one that hit her. I just gave her the roofie.
Roofie?
Forget me now.
You beat and drugged Rita?
Take this and love us again.
No,
just...
She'll sell the company or break it up into little parts or something, all under the guise of caring about our family.
Gotta stop quoting when you drink.
You ready for the prosecutor?
I hope so. How'd that math test work out?
Oh, it was okay, I guess, but I don't know, it was weird. I studied with Anne, but I still got a B-.
Anne got you a B-.
Well, it wasn't Anne. She's an expert in math. Isn't that cute?
Is it?
Michael felt his son was setting the bar too low with his dating standards.
No, it wasn't Anne's fault. You know, I think I just ended up thinking about the questions too long. And so by the time I put an answer down, I went with, like, my fifth choice or something like that.
Oh, George Michael, never settle for fifth choice. Something better is going to come along. She just has to.
I think maybe sitting in the back of the class with Anne is a bad idea. No, she's just so pretty. I get distracted, I guess.
Do you?
I wish I could draw her nose.
Maybe it's your eyes. Maybe you need glasses for your grades. You know, didn't you say you had a hard time reading the board, sitting in the back?
No, I said I was in the back of the classroom. That's different.
Oh, that's what I mean?
No, but...
Yeah?
Well, I don't know, maybe.
No, definitely. I'll call the eye doctor.
I guess.
I'm gonna set you up an appointment, okay?
Hey, gang.
Tobias.
I'm afraid I'll have to take them to go. I'm late for the gym. Oh, and also, here's a number in case the Blue Man Group calls and needs an understudy. I just found out that my cellular telephone was a lemon. It didn't work.
Coincidentally, neither do you.
We got a basket full of father-son fun here.
Good. What's Kama Sutra oil?
Maybe it's not for us.
Valentine's Day. When you... Whoa! Was your mother here?
Yeah. How's it going, brother?
You want to pop the trunk and roll the windows down, please?
Your son?
Yes, Rita. Yeah. Most important person in the world to me.
You really are quite a man, Michael.
Do you really think so?
Oh, yes. Okay. You're complete and utter.
I can't believe we had to bleep that. It would have been such a nice moment.
I'm just here to pick up my son's girlfriend. She ran off the last time we were leaving.
Actually, I was sitting right there the whole time.
Yeah, way to plant, Ann.
George Michael, listen, why don't you and Plant just wait in the stair car? I'm gonna finish up here with Joe.
I'm scared.
Wait, that's his girlfriend?
Yeah.
Was she funny or something?
Don't worry about it. Why do you keep thinking that I'm running away?
I mean, it is kind of suspicious. He didn't even ask me to drive down here with you.
Well, the only reason I didn't ask you to come with us is because of your chicken impression.
Yeah, we sure did get in a lot of trouble for that last time, didn't we?
Oh, yeah.
I was all, remember?
Get off of me. He doesn't know what he's doing. He's American.
Americano, eh? Just like me.
Gene Parmesan, how you doing?
Gene, what the hell are you doing?
Oh, no, we're making it worse. Prepare to be swallowed into the depths of hell.
So I guess that means no kiss?
I'm not really in the mood for a kiss. This isn't Mark Cherry's house.
Kitty left me 2 days ago. There's a blue handprint on the back of your head, Kitty. Are you seeing someone else?
Face it, Tobias. It's over.
What?
Say goodbye to these.
Those are blue, too.
There were blue handprints on them?
Yes. As it turns out, the part that I'd destroyed my life to get had already been cast.
The role was filled by George Sr., who used it to hide in plain sight. That is, until he choked on a marshmallow and almost died when no one noticed he'd turned blue. Tobias, still hoping to be in Job's trick, ventured into a costume shop he'd stumbled upon.
Oh, look who's back.
Years earlier.
Are you gonna buy this time, or are you just curious?
I suppose I'm, bi-curious.
Okay. She's a shot putter, and I'm dating her, but
I just want to make sure that you're comfortable with everything.
Well, of course, we could double date. You and Sally, and me and Anne.
Who?
Well, Anne.
Yes.
And we had...
Yes. Of course I know Anne. Yes, yeah, I didn't mean who. I meant, her? That's a great idea. I love Anne.
Great.
Excuse me, ma'am?
A traumatized Steve Holt needs a father.
I've made a huge mistake. I know the feeling. I had you.
I'm your father, Steve Holt. I can't hide from it anymore.
I won't forget this, Dad.
I will.
I really fancy you.
I fancy you too.
Michael was falling for Rita.
Lindsay, this is appalling.
What do you use for misdirection?
Misdirection?
Yeah, I mean, if you're so good at magic, what'd you have them looking at to divert their attention?
Well, I don't know. My ass.
My ass? You're lying.
No, I'm not.
You're gonna take that back.
No, I'm not. This has nothing to do with you. You're not my father.
No, our father is in prison for stealing, remember? Which might not be a bad place for you to get used to.
Michael, it was shoplifting and I'm white. I think I'm gonna be okay.
Shoplifting? Cool, can you take me?
You know, say what you will about America, 13 bucks still gets you a hell of a lot of mice.
Mice!
Mice! Prosecute
me! Michael, I'm not as bad an influence as you think I am.
Well, you're not a great one. You're a criminal, Lindsay. What kind of message does that send?
Bluth, we're ready to question you now.
I am, Michael. I'm a shoplifter. I've got a whole bag of clothes I shoplifted.
But Tobias was now a guard. And a surprisingly cat-like one.
Next time, don't pocket it. Pay for it.
I mean, come on.
Remember me?
Lucille. Why, you look younger than you did the day I...
Oh, you old fool. I'm Lucille.
Ah! You look fabulous. Back to the blonde. Back to the blonde. Isn't she beautiful? Oh, yeah.
Remember Lucille?
No, I don't. Get me a vodka rocks.
Mom, it's breakfast.
And a piece of toast.
Please, Stan Sitwell's coming over.
That hairless freak is coming here? None of his hair is real, you know.
You mean the guy we're meeting with can't even grow his own hair? Come on!
Michael was trying to include his brother in the business at his father's request.
So, the last couple of months have seen us hemorrhaging money.
But he was finding himself overwhelmed by the change.
Is it my turn to speak yet? I've got a good one.
You're gonna wait till after lunch for the tricks.
That's not a trick, Michael. It's a business opportunity. Okay, you can turn the music off. I already shut my wad. Off. But that's tape. I have got a quick way for us to literally be showered with money. That's where the penny thing went. Bonus. Anyway, it involves us making some money with our Mexican friends from Colombia.
I think they're called Colombians.
Oh, I forgot. We're being politically correct.
As you may or may not know, Lindsay and I have hit a bit of a rough patch.
Really? When did that start?
Well, I don't want to blame it all on 9/11, but it certainly didn't help.
Who alerted the Japanese?
I think you might have a spy. This room or someone in it might even be wired with a listening device.
I'll fry up some bacon.
Oh, Dad!
Buddy, you gotta take it easy, okay? I'm showing this as a model again. I don't want people to think we've got shoddy workmanship.
That might not have been your fault.
I know. Nothing works in this house.
Tell me about it.
Is that a shot at me?
Probably.
Because for your information, I got a job.
Really? What kind of job?
Beads.
Bees?
Beads.
Beads?
Job's not on board.
Here you go, Merry Christmas. Where the hell is my brother?
Sure. The guy in the $600 banana suit. Come on!
The only thing I ask is, out of the 450 homes we build, one be given to a disadvantaged family from the inner city.
That's great. So the other 449 families live in fear? Is that what we're saying? I mean, come on! Where's your decent...
What the hell just fell off your face?
One of this guy's eyebrows just fell in the bowl of candy beans.
I always carry a spare.
Well, I hope you also carry a spare bowl of candy beans.
Joe, if they say, did you know of any financial improprieties, you'll...
Unbutton my shirt a bit and give him this look.
Not really sure what you're going for there.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I drank a lot last night.
Yeah, why were you drinking?
If I look like a man who made love to his wife last night, it's because I almost did.
That's why.
But Tobias had a low tolerance for alcohol.
You look very handsome.
And so you just finished off the bottle?
Well, I had to. It's vodka. You know, it goes bad once it's opened.
Would it kill her to let some vodka go bad?
Oh, no, vodka doesn't.
You know, it's my birthday in a week, and I bet you they don't even know. They forget every year. I should just move out.
Well, but they're planning a surprise party for you. They wouldn't forget your 16th birthday.
Oh, my gosh, our little girl's turning 14.
16, actually.
Well, I am off to buy the perfect present. Maybe she'd like a suit like this.
That is her suit.
Yeah, they probably don't make it in a woman's, though.
They only make it in a woman's.
Well, I'm off, my love.
How does he know about her?
Hmm?
Didn't he just say that Job should be ashamed of himself?
No, but give it a little while. Somebody will. What's all that for?
It's for my out-of-town act.
Out-of-town, Job? You know, the prosecution is watching every move we make.
Michael, I'm just going to Iraq.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not. Dad is up on treason charges for building homes in Iraq.
It's a USO tour.
You're not going.
Yes, I am. And I'm doing my whole Christian magic act that my religious girlfriend helped me work out. I dress up like Jesus, walk on water, which you've seen. I'm going to do the wine into water.
It's water into wine.
Well, and I just emptied out all your wine bottles and filled them with fake stuff for nothing.
Great. How am I supposed to have sex with my husband now?
Wanted to tell you how much I miss you.
Oh, let this little black...
I got myself a date with a beautiful woman named Rita, and you're the chicken, not me.
Okay, that's a pretty good chicken.
Let's start with my family's misdemeanors, and then we're gonna push right on through to the lighter treasons. The Japanese backers, if they find out about this, that we haven't started building, they might not come through with their investments. And he siphoned off the entire pension fund into a dummy corporation, filed for bankruptcy, and used... Do you know any other songs?
She's a spy.
Rita is not a spy, okay? She's a beautiful, elegant woman. Doesn't make any sense.
What doesn't make any sense is why she's dating you.
No, that's a good point. Actually, my sources tell me that the leak goes by the name Mr. F. Mr. F.
Ah, Mr. F. Rita's not a man.
As far as you know.
And it could be an alias.
Alias is a show about a spy.
Put the ether on the puppet's lips. Have the puppet kiss her.
I ain't kissing that old bitch. That's my wife, you bastard.
Dad, that's my wrist.
Hey, man, that's his neck.
And Tobias was finding her an uncannily difficult blind girl to outmaneuver. Their game of cat and mouse continued. Until Michael showed up to return justice.
Oh, justice, what is it, boy? What is it? Is there some jackass in my bathrobe? I can't stay!
What he saw was a story about his wife giving mouth to mouth to a homeless man, but he knew the truth. She was kissing his brother. Tobias West loses his security job trying to solve the store's mice problem. Lindsay, now without a job, goes with her initial instinct.
No, I think mine's worse. You should have seen what happened to me on the boardwalk today. They were laughing at me. Me!
This pig, Philip Litt, is out there asking girls to take their tops off. It's an outrage.
Well, of course you feel that way. You're jealous. You're a surfboard. But I do agree, he is a pig. Hey, what the hell was that for?
Can we stop worrying about girls with low self-esteem and start focusing on sobering up the woman who gave us ours? Seriously, what do you think about rehab?
Well, she won't go willingly, I can tell you that.
May I make a suggestion? Get implants.
Really?
What? Come on! This stuff is expensive!
Takes his queen and showers her with diamonds!
Clubs. Club sauce.
He covers her with club sauce.
All right, that'll be my line if that happens.
Is that a magic trick? I love magic.
I don't appreciate the dry British humor.
Please do a magic trick for me.
Well, I shouldn't. I'd hate to be blamed for setting another one of Michael's brides on fire!
Oh, lighter fluid like Uncle Trevor uses. But wherever did it come from?
Okay, I've got to get you into an illusion at the wedding.
Maybe you can point out to your mother that your father hasn't arrived yet.
So, my father's not here.
Maybe he is.
Anne just called. They had a pre-dawn mass, and then they're going to go to mass, so...
Well, Anne's got a great deal of mass.
Tobias met with the prosecutor, Wayne Jarvis.
A flower in my garden, a mystery in my panties.
Bother you.
Buster finds someone else interested in kissing his hook.
Oh, God!
Drug dog's got something. Get him, bit it!
So Buster gets a hook replacement.
They're not going to let you in at the country club with that.
I don't want no part of your tight-ass country club, you freak bitch!
It was at that exact moment that Buster did forget he'd lost his hand.
Oh! No, stop it, stop it, stop it! Oh, you caught my tendon in your claw!
My claw?
I'm a monster!
Besides, I'm going to Anyang's soccer award ceremony, and...
Oh, no.
And I don't need the other soccer moms knowing how old my first batch of kids are.
Yeah, I think that they're gonna know that Anyang's not... Would somebody please tell this insufferable child of God?
He offered me a job.
What?
Well, I'm not waiting on my brother. I pass.
You look surprised.
I'm sorry, I must have put it on too high. But you were right. It was a bad offer and you were smart enough not to take it. You got gumption, you speak your mind. That means you're good enough to work for me.
F*** you.
Come closer.
It's weighing heavy on my soul.
You know, the Talmud teaches us to, there you go.
What's he doing?
He's pinching the camera.
He's on to us. He's found the camera.
Get out of there. Got the camera. Abort.
Get the dog.
Abort.
Clean the dog. We are cleaning the dog.
There's going to be plenty of money to be made from a business run honestly.
Oh, well, your mom's not going to allow for that.
She'll do whatever it takes to get her way. You think the banana stand... was our idea?
It wasn't?
It wasn't. Although they marketed the idea better, the frozen banana itself was the brainchild of a Korean immigrant who threatened to sue them.
Your mother said she'd take care of it. The guy was deported to Korea the next day.
Where his business never recovered.
That was a very important phone call.
I don't have much time, Michael. Tobias is about to walk in here any minute asking for a job, and I need you to hire him.
Hi, I'm...
Look, it isn't my idea, it's his. But I need a break from Mrs. Featherbottom.
Since moving out, Tobias had been pretending to be a British housekeeper as a way to be close to his family. However, his desire to now be discovered as himself was becoming bothersome.
Can't you just tell him you know that he's Mrs. Featherbottom?
Oh, no, no. She's the only one who can hand wash my delicates.
Yeah, the real Tobias wouldn't do that.
Wouldn't do what?
Be Michael's assistant.
Well, that's what I came down here to ask about.
I think you'll find me more than qualified.
It's really not that simple. You'd have to submit a resume.
Booyah!
Wow, Jobias Industries.
Gobias.
Right.
As in Gobias.
I remember, yeah. You know what? Looks like you might be a little too qualified.
Hang on. Why don't you let your new assistant take all this down?
Michael, Starla told us about the cutback. You know, a lot of our overhead is tied up in the fact that we are on the top floor of a very expensive building. If we move just one floor lower...
Ted, everything's fine. I got it all under control, and nobody needs to move.
I'm sorry, Ted?
Yes.
Is it Ted? Did Ted make an appointment?
No, I just worked down the hall.
No. Well, then Ted can get the hell out of this office! You get the hell out!
And that's how you keep out unwanted visitors.
Thank you.
Although, if I may,
let me take off my assistant skirt and put on my Barbra Streisand in The Prince of Tides ass-masking therapist pantsuit.
What? Hey, why aren't you in there?
Oh, I was just keeping on young company. Give me that bagel. Give it to me! Oh, our star witness. Come here.
Oh. Good to see you. You know what? Don't get too close to me, because I've got an itch you can't believe. I think something laid eggs on me.
Well, right. Thanks for the heads up.
Here, it's okay.
Hey, brother.
Who you calling brother, you hook ass?
Mother!
Job, I'm going hunting for my wife.
You keep this to yourself. I help you get Sally. Siphon a little something from her car. You show up in the Corvette looking like a man. Car troubles?
You know, I'm thinking of asking Anne to get pre-engaged.
You are?
Yeah. Well, I feel like God moved her here from Ohio just to be with me.
Huh?
Well, that's the first I've heard of this.
Well, then who said her?
Me. That was me. But, her?
No hair. They've got no hair.
While Stan Sitwell used the game to raise funds for underprivileged children.
Uh-oh, I think one of your orphans is heading toward the street. You're right, three.
I'll win the game. And I'll show him that his little plan didn't work, all right? We can build houses, we can win games.
That is what I want to hear.
We can win games. Lindsay, did that oven vent hit you? Your foot is bleeding.
My foot is bleeding.
Temacil may cause numbness of the extremities.
You're still going to be able to play on our team this weekend, right?
Why do you think I'm taking Temacil?
To curb your sex drive.
That's right. What team are you talking about?
It may also cause short-term memory loss.
Do you want to say something, or should I, Tobias?
No. I believe in letting children learn from their mistakes, Michael. They make a mistake once, they shan't make it twice. Oh, there it goes! Don't worry, it has not fallen into the garage. Knock on wood.
Oh, she's no bigger than one of my legs. Shake them for her.
Excuse me, Uncle Jack, I'm George, Michael.
It's okay. Just ignore it. Ignore it. Just something the body does when you're shaken. Don't shake it. Don't shake it. Oh!
Not the good one.
Is he dying? What if he's dying?
What the hell kind of puppet does Buster have on his hand?
Just let me think. God, Franklin, your breath. Oh, God.
Get over it.
Dad, Stan Sitwell liked my ideas. He really believed in me.
My ideas.
Wow.
And I'm president whether you like it or not, Dad. I don't need your approval anymore.
I'm proud of you.
Really?
Yeah, see ya.
Michael, I could have sworn I just saw Dad. Or not. I think hallucination is one of the side effects of Temacil.
It isn't.
Nice fur. You know, there's some nuts out there who'd want to throw red paint all over you. Wait a minute. I think there's one right over there.
Oh my God, you're...
Someone needs to read this.
And that's when Lindsay's heel went out.
Ow! No!
I got him! False alarm.
George Michael, I did not know that you were... go ahead and talk out here. Just got back from the bum paddle courts. Tomorrow, teaching her baseball.
Yeah, it might take a while.
Sorry?
I know what the shape of a banana reminds you of, and I know that when I say nuts, it makes you giggle. But do you have any other response to here's a banana with nuts? Why are we even going after this idiot demographic?
Maybe don't you get it? They're not even eating these. They just like saying bananas and nuts, and I won't tell you why. That's your father's job.
Come on, let's see some bananas and nuts. Oh, perhaps we should just pull their pants off.
Stop it, Buster.
Do it. I'm Joe Bluth. I'm the real magician. This man is only the assistant. Buster, the sword. Handle first. Oh, my fingers! It cut off my fingers!
That's good. Damn good.
I'm not kidding! He cut off my fingers!
Job went to check on the one friend who didn't mind having him around.
Get your loser hand out of my ass. Hello, son.
Oh, Dad. Dad? This is where you've been... Michael.
I just came back because of your mother. She's with my brother on my anniversary. And I got an idea from George Michael. I need to recommit myself to your mother.
Her?
Finally, where have you been?
The police had been delayed when they thought they'd cornered a kidnapping suspect.
Put your hands up or we'll take that as a sign of aggression against us.
They're not up!
He's aggressive!
Yeah, got a lot up.
I am getting married.
Who the hell to?
Who do you think? Rita.
Her?
Why?
Well, first of all, she needs a green card to stay in the country.
There it is.
She needs a green card to stay in the country because, secondly, we're really crazy about each other.
You hardly know her.
I know all the important stuff. She was in the Olympics. She's sweet, she's smart, she's beautiful, she's special.
Hot potato.
This is your wife. Didn't realize you could remarry.
What?
If he was here right now, I would probably tell him that it all worked out. And that, I'll be bringing you some salmon rolls right away. Heaven.
How many times do I gotta tell this kid chicken wings?
Lindsay got up to speak in an outfit her daughter had chosen.
My father meant the world to me. White mom. Give it away.
That's a home run.
Is it? It's a shamali.
It's gorgeous. I'm wearing it to dinner.
Oh, God, it's mom again.
Put it on speakerphone. I want to hear her beautiful voice.
Ah, Michael, there's a hole in the window. There's been a break-in. Get over here.
I'm leaving now.
Sounds tense. That means she's not getting any from my brother, Oscar.
Remember this. And the pledge that you made when you were promised it?
I said I'd do anything for it.
I want him out of the picture. Can you do that?
I'm a big girl.
And Michael returned home as well.
Hey, what happened to you?
Oh, I got highlights. It'll blend in about a week.
Look at all the Barbies! Oh no, my wig seems to have run off.
On George Sr., as it turned out.
I'm Mrs. Veal.
Sorry, I did not expect somebody so young.
Next you're gonna say how Anne and I can be sisters.
No, I'd never say that.
I mean, I couldn't get over the wall. They put me on suspension until I can.
Well, perhaps you need to find somebody who can motivate you.
Yeah, but who?
And then it hit him.
Next up, we've got last year's charity case, Lindsay Fuenke.
Lindsay showed up.
Oh, no, not again.
Although she was still feeling the effects of the tranquilizer.
$100, folks?
Stick a wrench in me. I'm done.
Yes. But let's go right now, okay? Before my uncle gets out of the shower for some more cigarettes. You take that. I gotta leave a note.
But there was one piece of intelligence that Michael didn't have.
Interesting.
Don't even think about it, Jay. She's an MRF.
MRF? What's that?
Mentally retarded female.
That explains what she's doing with him.
And the hats.
Don't you think they're a bit too young?
Oh, we got series around his age.
Well, who can blame you? You gotta lock that down.
Job finally makes the cover of Poof magazine.
So you came back here to hide like a child.
What are you doing locked in my office exactly?
Hiding from a child. Big difference.
Job, Steve Holt is your son. He probably just feels a connection.
He doesn't know what he feels. I'm tired of being told. My God, what is this feeling?
You know, the feeling that you're feeling is just what many of us call a feeling.
But it's not like envy or even hungry.
Could it be love?
I know what an erection feels like, Michael. No, it's the opposite. It's like my heart is getting hard. Maybe I am ready to be a father.
Hey, Dad. Oh.
It's my son, Joe. Since you're devastating people, go ahead and tell Job that I'll be telling the cops that it was him in the truck, so he'll be joining me here. I've got a nice hard cot with his name on it.
You do that to your own brother?
I said cot. Mrs. Veal.
Jolly news, Governor. Young master's proposing.
George Michael? I told him not to. He said he wouldn't.
Well, this was before he saw you pounding that sweet piece of veal.
I mean, why get his hopes up?
Yeah, that's better.
Knock, knock.
Oh, God!
Monster!
Hey, brother.
Buster!
Buster!
Sorry about the window.
Not a problem.
I really hate this stupid hook. But I certainly can't walk around like this.
No, why not?
Very handsome.
I think she misses my brother.
My father?
Yes? I mean, yes.
Now I got a special thank you for the brother who made this happen.
Is that Franklin?
And Michael realized that he could never turn his brother in. Job, meanwhile, was having a similar epiphany.
Do it for you.
Barry, it's Job. Tell Michael not to testify. I'm bringing in Dad.
Franklin, you've ruined the act, Job.
Joe made me kiss Franklin, and I think my father was here.
Maybe he still is.
Well, shut up. What do you mean he was here?
I think he was dragging my mother out with Job.
Oh, you shut up.
A house is terribly hard to make.
Actually, the hardest part is finding the land.
But she wasn't smart.
Instead of making houses, maybe you should make land.
For Rita had only mentally progressed...
on the ocean.
...to the level of a first grader.
There's no land on the ocean.
Michael might have noticed her disability if it had not been masked by her English accent.
You were brilliant.
Yeah, she wasn't.
I can't believe you're not supporting this.
Because it is obvious what she's after.
Our money.
Oh, God, our money.
Let's just all relax and remind ourselves that we don't have any money.
She's already gotten our money.
I know she's a really, really good person, and everything else is going to be little surprises along the way.
With the exception of that one big one.
The wedding is in 1 month.
Oh. A month?
Now look, just because a woman gets pregnant doesn't mean you have to marry her. Too many lives have been ruined because some cheap waitress at a Hojo said she used an IUD.
It was Stuckey's.
But I believed you.
She's not pregnant. Truthfully, we haven't even slept together.
Oh, this is funny.
He's gay!
Where's your hand?
Oh, I'm having my high school ring put on it. And my hook is stuck in the stair car.
What's going on?
We're trying to figure that out. Apparently, Pop-Up kidnapped Gangi, and I have no idea where George Michael is, or Lindsay.
I just saw them drive off. They're going to go look for Bland. Who's the hottie?
This is Anne's mother.
Her?
Back at the country club, something unusual had happened.
Oh, I don't have any drugs for sale. Unless, did you expect me to follow you to your car?
They're your tips.
Tips.
And Job realized he'd accidentally worked a day in his life.
This family has got to stick together.
I don't want Job coming to this dinner.
Good idea.
Guess where he's been getting his money?
Is he following people to their cars again?
He's a waiter!
He is? Well, that's great.
No, it's not great.
Well, am I the only one that thinks that this family is finally starting to become sympathetic and relatable? I mean, that's what people want to see, you know? Lindsay's taking care of the house.
Oh. Oh, I forgot about that. Tell the housewife she's not coming either.
If you don't want her, you don't want me either. She's taking care of me. She glued my thumb back on. Sister's my new mother. And is it just me, or is she looking hotter, too?
Well, why don't you marry her?
Maybe I will!
We're veering away from relatability again.
George Sr. shows up to bid on Lucille. But the sound of his wolf call and the smell of chicken teriyaki interfere.
No! Oh, no.
Maybe we should emphasize athletics a little bit more in this family. Now, start us off with a protein drink, okay? Still doing that, huh?
So as you can see, any rumor of a mole problem is completely untrue.
But unfortunately, this was just as Tobias appeared in his rented mole outfit.
Ow!
I'm very particular about building codes. And this water tower does not pass muster. Lucille?
Who can save our village?
Michael.
As it turned out, it was George Michael, who had finally gotten his grandfather's jetpack to work.
Here's my advice to you. Go ahead and take yourself a goodie bag and get out of here while you can.
The speech was disturbing, the food inedible, and the gift bags pretty frightening. And when Job realized he wouldn't get tipped...
No, where's everyone going?
The service got a little worse.
No one's leaving until I get my money! I'll follow you to your cars!
Oh, and then that old racist woman choked on Buster's thumb.
This lady can't breathe!
All in all, it was one of the Bluths' better dinner parties.
I do think we should go for a run, huh? Some real guy stuff.
I'm supposed to go fabric shopping with Ann today.
I think we can go butcher.
Can I ask you a question? Are all the guys in here, you know...
Oh, no. Not all of them.
Yeah. It's never the ones you hope.
Oh, think.
Meanwhile, Michael and Buster had retrieved Buster's hook and were staking out the situation.
Gypsies. Hey. They've changed into gypsies.
I'll be waiting out here with my enlistment form, so go in there and scare them right into my open arm!
But as it turns out, the fair had two startled straight tents. And George Sr. had wandered into the church-sponsored one.
You want to be some guy's girlfriend?
Intended to scare gay young men into a heterosexual lifestyle.
Want to have some guy reach around you in the middle of the night, start messing with your junk?
Is he ugly?
No, it's pitch black. You don't see him. And it never stops, guys. And everybody acts like it's no big deal.
Is there a cover charge?
Meanwhile, George Sr. hadn't succeeded in startling anyone but himself.
I mean, there's nothing to do all day except lift weights and fold laundry, get thrown into a cage with a bunch of sweaty men. Excuse me. I can't go back.
Well, I'm glad he won't be there.
They each enjoyed the activities of their romantic getaways.
Body chocolate?
No.
Of course, in the spa, the jets proved too powerful for Uncle Jack's tiny legs.
We're making a gown. She's going to be in a beauty pageant.
Yeah, who's Anne?
My girlfriend. She's... You've met her so many times. You've met her and met her.
No, I know who Annabelle is. Who's the Anne that's in the beauty pageant?
That's her. Her name isn't Annabelle. That's Anne.
Right, no, I know that her name is not Annabelle. That's how I remember her name, because her body is going to shape like a... She's the belle of the ball. What is she doing in the beauty pageant? She running the lights or something? You all right?
Oftentimes, the heart acts without consulting the head. And thusly, I bear... Well, I see you wasted no time in filling my seat hole.
Oh, no. I just came by so that you could say goodbye to these.
Oh, no.
It's the last time you're going to be seeing these for a while.
How ironic. I just found out I'm staying. We take these back.
Okay. Let's just all put our tops down. Let's just put them on down.
Michael, I know you're in the middle of something, but I'm afraid I can't work for you today. I'm going to Vegas with Kitty.
But Lindsay wasn't about to lose her man without a fight.
Over my dead body!
Oh, my God.
Well, gee, I didn't think the woman I'd be checking out at spring break would be Mom.
She's better looking than the whores you date.
Don't call my escorts whores.
Mom still got it.
I don't date whores!
Stop it! Stop it! This objectification of women has to stop.
It's just Mom and whores.
No, how would you like it? Actually, that's not a bad idea. I should turn the tables on men and see how they like being objectified. Men with low self-esteem. Get their clothes off.
That is a great... social statement. I shall get the video camera. This is ripe for parody. This is ripe!
He just wants to see boys' linuses. Oh, God.
How has God influenced your life?
About just as much as Big Bird and the Keebler Elves.
Well, my faith would have been shaken if you'd taken my legs, too.
Joe Bluth, state. I was betrayed by my brother Michael. Who's your favorite family member and why?
Definitely not my shallow materialistic mother who only cares about looks.
I think we all feel that way about our mothers. And we all have legs.
Oh, forgot my iPod.
And so Michael, believing himself to be aided by Joe, set to work. But this, too, produced less than compelling footage. And this is how that ended.
Put on the sound effects, put on the sound effects. CD1. Hi. Hey, why don't you pop a tent in front with your cousin, maybe?
What? No.
I'm not really the outdoorsy type.
Well, this is a good chance for you to rub off on her.
Will it be the beautiful Hope Loblaw, the stalwart Annabelle Veal, or the justifiably bitter Shirley Wolfbeak?
It became clear that Shirley was going to win.
I'm sorry. This is wrong.
And that's when Maybe displayed some real inner beauty.
One of these girls deserves to win.
She can stand.
Maybe?
That's how I know her.
Let us pray.
Oh, for God's sake.
I just need to prove to my wife that I can act like a man. And it's not about sex. I
don't just lie there if that's what you're thinking.
That's not what I was thinking.
Sorry, just a quick question from Michael.
Is this about the money?
No.
What do you want?
I mean, it's not about money in the sense that I'm coming here saying, here, Michael, take some money. It's just more of a, may I have some kind of visit.
Don't you have a wife that you can ask now?
She left me.
For Tobias?
For me?
No. She doesn't even like you.
I'm in love with your brother-in-law.
You're in love with your own brother? The one in the army?
No, your sister's husband.
Michael. Michael.
No, that's your sister's brother.
No, I'm my sister's brother. You're in love with me. Me.
I'm in love with Tobias.
My brother-in-law?
I know it can never be, so I'm leaving. I'm enlisting in the army.
Be with your brother.
No!
Bob's daughter, Hope. Well, if I can get Hope this crown, maybe her father might just want to crown me. If you know what I mean.
I'm guessing have sex, but that's meeting you more than halfway. Tobias, want to clean up that mirror? And face?
Perhaps if I can coach a certain young lady to victory in this pageant, I can gain back the respect of my wife. I'll show them a little TNA.
You can't make me do it, John.
Tobias and Anne. Within her lies a queen. Let me out that queen.
Yeah, I think you just did.
Michael.
Joe?
Oh, let me get that for you. So, a young neighborhood tough by the name of Steve Holt's gonna be here any minute.
Your son?
According to him.
And a DNA test.
I heard the jury's still out on science.
Claiming she could take it no more, the young mother released the emergency brake, allowing her car to roll backwards into the nearby lake.
Good for her.
Robot will get it.
That was my maid.
Robot!
But the robot was busy elsewhere.
What do you expect, Mother?
I'm half machine. I'm a monster!
Hey, hello. Well, look at you two, Tweedledee, Tweedledum.
Michael didn't mean it in that way. How could he? He didn't even know.
You want to get away from me so bad? You're free.
But I'm free too, baby. I'm staying in the conjugal trailer with the warden tonight.
Him?
Lucille arrives at the cabin.
Hey, there's no cabin. Down, so down.
Mother?
Oh my God! You still doing breakfast burritos?
Maybe find someone to help her forget her cousin.
Stood up.
Yeah, me too.
Her cousin.
You want to make out?
Yeah, sure, why not?
And Lindsay catches up with Tobias.
Get your hands off my husband, Kitty.
Did someone say husband?
Ah, here comes the bride.
Hey, what are you doing in a wheelchair?
No, it's a dolly to help videotape your nuptials.
I don't think I need any footage of my nuptials. Tobias, are you sure that this dolly isn't related to your recent health problems?
Okay, so my legs and my left arm occasionally go to sleep, and you want to call it a health problem.
Oh! Hey.
Oh, I can get up myself. Oh! Ah! Here we go! Wow. Let me get in the dolly. No, thank you. I don't need your help.
Scrape. The only thing more terrifying than the escaped lunatic's hook was this twisted call.
Hey, campers. I'm a monster!
Thanks, buddy. Hey, look at that. We didn't get swallowed up into hell.
And that's when George Michael finally got close to Maybe, who, by the way, might not be his biological cousin. Just then, however, Job came home to retrieve his father from where he'd stashed him.
Dad's gonna be crushed.
You don't have to tell him.
But Job was referring to his own father, who he had hidden under the house.
Uh-oh.
What is that?
Feedback.
Someone else wired?
Oh, that's me. My friend Frank wired me. He wanted me to be a mole.
Our cover's blown. Let's get out of here.
George Sr., disoriented in the walls, almost makes contact with a new mole. Not that one. Wait for it.
Anya? Hello?
Mom wants to sleep with the warden.
What?
Oh, God!
Great.
Great? The man is old enough to be her contemporary, Lindsay. Plus, she's married, okay? She can't be writhing around underneath the covers.
What is wrong with you? It's disgusting, God.
Take it easy.
No, it's just I've always had a thing about Mom and Dad being together.
I know that.
I have a sense of propriety, my God.
Job, we've had this conversation.
When?
The last time you ended up seeing Mom and Dad go at it.
What? No, God, I did no such thing.
He did very much that thing when his parents got intimate in a conjugal trailer 2 years ago. But thankfully, he'd found a way to forget that.
I got a thing of pills in my pocket. I don't suppose I could convince you to grab me one.
Luckily, that worked too.
You sure you're okay?
Oh, probably. I can't feel anything. How's my hair?
It's fine. It's sucking the life out of you, Tobias. I mean, everything has gone crazy. The gala, Mom and Warden Gentles. I mean, what is in it for him? I think he's taking advantage of Mom.
Did it ever occur to you that maybe Warden Gentles likes her?
Likes her what?
No, I mean likes her, like is attracted to her.
Who's the her in that sentence?
Mom. Warden Gentles likes Mom.
Her?
Mm-hmm. Come on, let's have a fun. Rita Corny, Michael.
So Michael used a line that was just as corny.
You know, I think that we should wait until after we're married.
Married! Married, married, married! Okay, night-night!
And as George Michael acted like a boy becoming a man, Michael returned to his office to find a man acting like a boy.
Hey, what's this?
Just practicing my testimony. Need a fake witness box.
And you couldn't have just taken my stuff off the desk first? Or unplugged my computer?
Justice is swift, Michael. Plus, we need to be prepared for our testimony.
You're not doing any of that my name is judge stuff on the stand, okay?
No! They're all out of magazines at the hospital. Besides, I've got a better idea.
Which he got at the hospital.
Patient presented with gastric bacterial infection coupled with
peptic ulcers. Tetracycline should not be administered due to allergies.
Check this out. You'll say, who's this old friend? And I'll say, well, he's not really feeling that well. And you'll say, oh, what's wrong with the little guy? And he'll say,
patient presented with gastric bacterial infection.
Wow. Sounds like you could use some tricycling.
Tetracycline should not be administered due to allergies.
Your lips are still moving, and you stole the doctor's tape recorder?
It's the tape.
I'm giving it back to him.
Come on!
Doctor, when are we gonna know something? I'm trying to get on with my life.
Yeah, so is what remains of Buster.
Dr. Farmer, there's a problem in 302. The patient's having a bad reaction to the tetracycline.
Tetracycline? Didn't I say not to give him that? Didn't you listen to my notes?
What's the surrogate doing here?
We're meeting with a lawyer.
So I've hired this guy to be my eyes and ears.
You know, Dad, this guy costs us a fortune.
He's worth every penny.
Hey, I didn't say that.
Oh, Michael.
Mr. Loveland?
I'll catch you up. The Japanese are coming.
They are?
Somebody tipped them off that the property wasn't ready for building.
Which it would have been if Michael hadn't been so busy with his English muffin.
Typical.
Delicious.
I need a drink.
I'll take an English muffin.
Well, we'll just have to be honest with these Japanese investors. They come from a culture that values honor and respect.
And Godzilla. Roar! Roar!
Godzilla!
Okay, thanks.
Godzilla!
This needs to stop now. Okay, this is exactly what we shouldn't do when they show up. Mom, that's enough.
What? We're out of vodka.
Mom and Lindsay are pretending to be in rehab. I can't get a hold of Dad, and I have to fly to Iraq myself to get Joe.
Do you have to go by yourself?
Let me go with you. I was trained by army. I speak the language.
You speak Arabic?
Lahakat.
What's that mean?
Yeah, I was just clearing my throat. But I think it actually does mean laundry.
Now, why don't you go ahead and drive the stair car home, and Buster and I'll leave from here.
Well, be careful.
Hey, who's tougher than us? I want to get you your own banana stand franchise, and you can have Steve work at it.
You do that for me?
Yes. Yeah, you can design your own shack.
And choose my own location?
Whatever you want. You're going to be 100% in charge, all right? But the most important thing is that we never let Dad turn us against each other again.
Thanks, Michael.
If you feel something moving down there, it's just the bird.
I know it.
Hello? Can anyone see me?
Where's your hand, anyway?
Well, I haven't bothered getting dressed up. I have no one.
What, Buster, come on. Now, you know, if you're really lonely, maybe it's time you went out there and you got yourself a girl, a pet.
How about a turtle?
Great.
I'll give you two a moment.
Thank you.
I don't know why I always assume everyone's red my skin.
What is wrong with you? That man is being wonderful to us.
And that doesn't concern you, Mother? For all you know, he could be trying to seduce you.
Oh, Michael, you're crazy.
I certainly hope so.
I'm trying to seduce him.
Who's the I in that sentence?
Me.
You?
Her.
Well, I'll be honest, I haven't heard anything that beats herpes.
So they sent out invitations with the disease still to be announced. And much to their surprise, the Bluths ended up raising over $25,000 to fight TBA. And then, and here's the really horrible part, they did it again the following year.
Keep fighting, little guy. With your support of the Bluth Foundation, we'll live in a galaxy where TBA does not exist.
He was hiding from his cousin after an awkward incident. They'd since been trying to avoid each other, which was difficult considering they shared a bunk bed.
Oh, hi.
I'm off to the car.
I'll be in the crossing.
Look at this place. Look at my home.
Freeze! Drop the gun.
No, it's okay. We're just trying to teach this guy a lesson.
Drop the gun!
Oh, my God!
Hey, why is there an ambulance out front?
Honey, the car is here.
Hey, do you need a ride? I mean, you'll have to lie down, but...
I'm not going. The whole thing is a scam. Mom was just using that warden to try to get Dad out. She's not trying to seduce him at all.
I don't know. She is. She's spending the night with him. She just called to ask me to bring her a tube of vegetable paste. Hi, Judge Michael.
The Bluth boys found themselves in a strange land.
Leisurely, teisurely, Muffet time!
Oh! What did he say? Where are we?
He said he's taking surface streets to LAX because the freeway's backed up all the way to Knott's Berry Farm.
What's going on? You just thought you put the stand right here?
Did the research. Do you know that more frozen bananas are sold right here on this boardwalk than anywhere in the OC?
Don't call it that.
Also gonna need a check, because I kind of went out of pocket on the new sign. Oh, and I need some bananas and some chocolate from the other branch.
Just go ahead and just take the sign down. Take the whole booth down, as a matter of fact. You're cannibalizing our business.
You're just scared of a little competition.
Well, you know, you guys don't even have bananas, so I'm not too worried. In fact, you know what? Me and my son are gonna go ahead and kick your little shack's ass.
Dad, it's okay. We can just work together with them, you know?
Yeah, I mean, that makes sense. I mean, we don't really even know the recipe yet.
Oh, there's no recipe. You just freeze a banana and then you stick it in
don't
the
Don't tell him.
Stick it in the what? Stick it in the what?
No, it's okay, son. We'll figure it out.
You think this is gonna work?
It's a jetpack, Michael. What could possibly go wrong?
All right. Now, just make sure you tell me before you get any buttons.
Good. Now we know what the strap is for. Under the crotch.
Made a new plan.
Yeah.
Wish I knew the layout of this place.
Way ahead of you, Michael. Drew a map of it on my stomach. It's upside down, so it might be a little awkward.
It was awkward.
I drew us. I think we're like right there.
Hey, guys, if you're gonna party, you wanna bring it inside?
That was a freebie.
We need the number of the one-armed man.
I'm not giving you that. You wanna use his disability to scare someone. That's everything I'm against. Read the button, mister!
The only scary thing about a one-armed man trying to scare someone is the fact that
he feels that his one arm is good for nothing but trying to scare somebody.
It's upside down.
Well, let's say you try to put a button on with this.
Oh, stop screaming! It's not scary!
I'm gonna get the number myself, okay? Because we're not gonna go through our lives being controlled by this guy. What is more pathetic than grown men being scared of their father?
I'm thirsty.
This continued for a while.
Took me long enough.
Maybe you're not smart either. I didn't know until they told me.
Hey, why aren't we going to the airport?
Well, I want to go check out this house Dad asked you to burn down, see what he's hiding. I think that's it, sir. Buster, this guy speaks English.
Oh, no. I swallowed a moth.
Michael took off work to man the banana stand, while his son manned a banana.
How you doing there, champ?
Is my name Champ? It's so hot.
Okay, why don't you take five?
Yeah, it's not including the 5 minutes it takes me to get out of this thing, right?
You're not getting out of
Attention, everyone. Why go to a banana stand when we can make your banana stand? I give you Barbara and Dee. Don't worry, these young beauties have been nowhere near the bananas.
And are they strippers?
If I know your uncle, they're at least strippers. I guess we gotta up the ante.
No, Dad, then they're just gonna up it and it'll go back and forth all day.
If that's what it takes, that's what we're gonna do.
And they did. But it was less entertaining than you might imagine, no matter what music was put under it.
Big yellow joint, the big yellow...
What are you doing here? How'd you find me?
My dad said that you were living down here with your girlfriend.
You know about her?
Who?
Anne.
Her?
Why were you arrested by the Americans?
I was just doing a little off-mission street magic, trying to make a few dinars. And that is why Jesus was often referred to as the King of Kings. Queens. The King of Queens. And now I would like to behold one of the late great Jesus' biggest illusions, the burning bush.
Soon the security forces arrived to suppress what appeared to be an anti-American demonstration.
Hello, I'm Joe Blue. As a magician, I can make a lot of things disappear. There are some things I can't make disappear. No, not that candy ball machine. The disease GBH without your help. This is Tobias. When Toby first came into the family, none of us much wanted him around. But that's because we couldn't see what was on the inside. But lately, that's all we've been able to see. But what was Tobias to do? Have his hair plugs removed?
The doctor says I'd be completely healed if I were to do that.
He just needs his hair plugs out?
Doctor says that's the cure.
There's a cure?
No way. That horsehair is my ticket back into society. You cut it after those idiots at the gala accept me as one of their own.
We're giving money for this guy to keep his hair transplants?
I'd rather give to TBA.
They've put an N Bluth on the witness list.
Oh, that doesn't stand for what a thing stands for.
Whoa, I did not say that.
You did, Job. Your mouth moved, your hand didn't.
Oh, well, I should work on that.
Is there an N Bluth in the family that we don't know about? They say there's been money found in an account under that name.
Of course not. The prosecution is trying to test us, see if we're going to turn against each other. They make stuff up. She doesn't exist.
Yet you refer to her as a she.
He, she, what's the difference?
Oh, here, here. In the dark, it all looks the same. And they're probably just taking a shot in the darkness.
But the good news is that Jan Eagleman called, and she is willing to consider our case.
Jan Eagleman.
She's from the Justice TV.
Not another media whore. You know, frankly, I think I can put together a pretty good defense.
Oh, no, he thinks he's a lawyer again.
Devotees will remember that Michael once played a lawyer in a school play.
Michael, just because you played a role doesn't make it real.
Of course, Buster did grow up to be Captain Hook.
Not cool, Mom.
Where is George Michael, by the way?
He came by the yacht, gave me this shiner.
He hit you? What for?
You know, teenagers. Probably lashing out at you because of who I'm dating.
Who are you dating?
Anne.
Her?
Well, I know it was someone in this family. Or someone who used to be. Anya?
Annyeong.
Annyeong. But my real name is Hello.
Hello?
Annyeong.
What the hell did you do this for?
Because my grandfather vowed one day he would get even for banana sand you stole from him.
It was true. Hello had gathered information against Lucille.
Annyeong.
To avenge his grandfather.
Hey, maybe ever mentioned my name?
Oh, Michael, will you come visit me lots?
That's going to be difficult, really. You're going to be across an ocean.
Well, you can always walk.
Not on the water.
Oh, Michael, you're such a grown-up.
Hey, hey!
Hang on a sec. That's part of your trick, right?
No. That's not my trick, Michael. It's my illusion.
Michael relives a wedding nightmare.
Oh, put him out!
My hair! My beautiful hair!
Push him in the pool!
Why am I not going underwater? Dear God, why am I not going underwater?
Well, the big bear's not going to be around much anymore.
I don't care about that.
He's in denial.
We're getting divorced.
Your mother and I are getting a divorce.
Ah!
I want to know... I want to know about the stimulus package.
We haven't had sex since Christmas, Michael.
I'm sorry. You had sex 7 weeks ago? They were remodeling my room and I pulled my cot in there just like camp.
We yelled at you to leave.
Yeah, but then you whispered, don't pull out!
You
didn't want to use any of that money for... You couldn't use any of that money to finish Sudden Valley.
You don't consider that finished?
So the family got a little stimmy. Don't make a federal case out of it.
That is exactly what they're going to make out of it. And when you say family, you mean our family? They've already got their hooks in it. Buster, no offense.
None taken. I keep losing my jewels.
I'm sure Job helped himself to the money.
Hey, I got mouths to feed.
Mouths?
Mouth.
Oh, hey, Mouth. I didn't see you sitting there.
We rode up in the elevator together.
I'm blanking.
Dude, that's why I had so much fun at that party on the Queen Mary. And you paid for my haircut.
You pour it in the oven.
Making mother's breakfast. Top,
then you call your mother.
How did you like your egg?
I said you were fine.
So, was there something you wanted to talk about when you came in through my window?
Marry me.
Yes. Yes, I'll marry you, Job!
Of course, Job meant it in the show-busy way his niece had always used when she was accused of being too young.
What are you, like, 15?
Marry me.
Marry me.
Marry me.
And may I add,
marry me?
But like many evangelicals, Anne took it literally.
I'm getting married!
Oh, my God!
Job was surrounded by unconditional love from a family for the first time in his life.
Hello, darkness, my old friend.
I've made a huge mistake.
I've come to talk with you again.
And welcome to And As It Is Such, So Also As Such Is It Unto You.
Excuse me, Father Marsala, I hate to interrupt, but I am so excited today. My lovely Anne.
Who?
My daughter.
Oh, I didn't know you had a daughter.
You've met her several times.
Oh.
She's sitting right next to you.
Oh, that's why she's there. I thought you were Hare.
Hare? No, she's my daughter, and she's getting married to this good man.
Well, and as it is such, so also as such is it unto you, young man.
You got it.
I only propose to do this out of love. Love for...
Job's relationship with...
Anne.
And God. Love for and God. Let me pray.
Had come a long way.
Yo. State of California, them, bunch of California f***ers, yeah.
Do you know China Garden?
I know the downtown one. You know, I shouldn't judge, because you have friends, and I envy that. You're welcome to my friends, brother. I don't want these.
You know, your whole life is an escape act. And this girl seems like she really likes you. Why don't you just try to work it out and just stop running? Yeah, I know you're in the Boulder.
But how'd I get in the Boulder?
I guess having matching luggage isn't so romantic anymore. And these romantic gestures are possibly why people think I'm a homosexual. Well, it's time to correct old misconceptions. And that is why I'm making a new start.
A new start, filled with compassion and love. I like that.
Well, I've already got the license plate, so go cry in your pie.
And so Tobias, hoping to straighten out his image, set out on a new start. Tobias sat with his wife's family, feeling lost.
Because you look like I feel.
And very misunderstood.
Gay?
No, I... No. Who?
Hello, darkness, my dog.
We have almost arrived at that glorious moment where we join together these two very special people. But first, my almost son-in-law has something he'd like to share with all of us.
Thanks for that killer intro.
I'm Lindsay, and you're Batami.
No, I don't like giving my name to any state organizations, especially after I got kicked off the voter rolls, because I accidentally signed up for the wrong political group.
What group was that?
You know, I don't even remember. Just some guy in a booth on the boardwalk.
He joined Al-Qaeda.
I'm Marky Bark.
Of the Tree Freer Barks?
Marky was the son of Johnny Bark, an activist that Lindsay had once helped save and then kill a tree.
Oh my God, I remember thinking one day he was just gonna fall out of a tree and break his neck. Whatever happened to him?
He fell out of a tree and broke his neck.
It's just so refreshing to meet people with real passion about changing the status quo.
Lindsay and I don't have a single friend.
Is the food here yet?
I'm not hungry, but,
No cheese!
Oh, look, it's butter!
Debris.
Woo!
Debris, that's our butter. We were gonna swap it for dessert.
But Tobias interpreted this as method one acting.
No, she's improvising. Yes, ma'am. You seem to be liking that butter substitute of swapping ins.
What do you mean you didn't make dinner? I didn't realize it was Thursday, okay? There's gotta be something here.
Oh! Oh! That's a good duck.
Good duck.
In you go. This is going to be the greatest Thanksgiving ever.
Michael did the only thing he could think of that would save face.
You make love like a boy.
Spanish. Speak to me in Spanish. Because the only way that college credit is actually activated is if I have...
Toma me.
Cooking at you?
Overpower me. Oh, yes. Make me cry.
You're a terrible mother.
Oh, 43. But that's because I'm good with numbers. Oh, no, actually, it's 34.
Well, if it's dumb to stay behind with you, call me a dummy.
We don't say dummy. And unfortunately, you two algitards are gonna need some special tutoring.
Which is how they found themselves headed to the local college along with the other math challenge students. As it turned out, Buster returned on the very day the Army policy regarding sexual orientation had changed.
Are you gay?
No.
You could tell me.
I'm not.
It's okay. Sure, tell him. I'm gay.
Oh.
Peter's gay.
Oh.
Sergeant Melnick's gay.
Bye.
Oh, sorry, he's bye.
No, I'm going home for the day. I'm gay.
You have been warned.
I don't know what you saw, but I got an ostrich and no boner.
It smells weird in here. What is that?
I think it's just not urine. And we're not moving in. We're occupying a space with central air.
Cindy? It was also being occupied by Lindsay's own daughter.
What do you think?
Whom Lindsay believed was living with her father.
We're not
moving in, we're... The Army had taken advantage of Buster's childlike inability to distinguish between games and reality by making him a drone pilot.
You're not gonna get away from me, little nurse.
He had been playing for 47 straight hours.
Take that, Taliban wedding!
But like anyone who plays video games for too long, he started to make mistakes.
Hey, Luke, you just took out an art museum in Madrid.
Oh, you can get a Spain in this thing?
Maybe you should take a break. You could have hurt some innocent people.
Innocent people? You mean I've been hurting guilty people?
But Buster was a peaceful man and didn't take well to this notion.
Pilot down!
It was the kind of emergency that the drone pilot paramedics had long been waiting for.
I got a man down!
Sorry we're late. Some kid swallowed an eye at the Build-A-Bear. Why do they have us at a mini mall?
If this guy comes after us, they could pull funding for the whole program.
So, how do we buy off old one arm?
Well, first, we gotta find something he needs.
Well, we do have the bionics program.
Ice cream!
Maybe we shouldn't be discussing this here. Damn these mini malls.
So you fell out of a chair, and for this the government gives you applause?
No, a big hand.
No, Lindsay, we're together.
But they wouldn't
wait,
be
wait
for
a
long.
Second.
Because after the methadone
driving.
Made Debris think
it's
she was a piece
so
of toast.
Refreshing.
I mean, that's our butter. We were gonna swap it for dessert.
No, she's improvising.
Tobias ended up connecting with her in the ladies' room.
See a pretty face under all that butter substitute? And I recognize you from somewhere, but it's not the Fantastic Four. It's from somewhere else.
I've done some things I'm not proud of.
Episodics? Been there.
She had been in a series of softcore porn movies about women leading straight men into gay sex called
This is my
straight
brother. Bit. He's gay. If you want to have sex with me, then you've got to have sex with him first.
And if you don't want to have sex with her, you must be
Show
gay.
You how not gay I am.
She did six of these movies. And after lunch, did three more.
Bet it's been a long time since you've seen your Sherry.
I have lupus.
Could have warned a guy.
You didn't leave me. Everybody leaves me.
I wouldn't dream of it.
Excuse me. Could you leave us
yeah,
alone?
Absolutely, yes.
Thank you.
Oh, no, I'd like him to stay.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm afraid that you've tested positive for chlamydia, syphilis, gonorrhea, hepatitis, pancreatitis, trichomonitis, non-gonococcal urothritis, all the itises, really. And there's also a host of ossises. Now, what this means in non-medical terms is that you have landed a real party girl.
It's about to do a magic trick for you.
No, it's an illusion. A trick is something a whore does.
Do a trick and I'll pay for your bar tab.
Who wants a trick?
Yeah!
Job had them in the palm of his hand. It even got the attention of a young actress named Rebel Alley, who was there doing research for an upcoming PSA. She'd soon be required to do by law.
Never yell fire in a crowded place. It's never funny.
I mean, come on.
Rudy, what are you doing?
We're broke.
Well, but you can't sell your Fantastic Four costume.
No, I was gonna have sex with them. For money.
No, put that back on. You don't have to degrade yourself this way.
Hey, I'm not a thing.
Hey, I am a thing.
George Michael couldn't imagine it was the same maybe.
Is this F in maybe F her last name or her grade?
It's her last name, but her most recent grade is, well, this just shows an Elvis Presley head.
So that bad. I'll take her.
Stay on top of her. You may need to ride her pretty hard. Don't be afraid to crack the whip.
All right, guys, what we got?
It's quiet out there.
Yeah, we better be ready. Yeah, I'm a man. Don't make it look like makeup.
Car.
Check out one of ours.
Look at the license plate.
Looks like we got ourselves an anus tart.
Yes, Tobias had hit rock bottom.
Big Daddy, I thought I'd try to call you before I surprised you. Things are really looking up. And, hello? Oh,
damn it. What Sun Valley does to these cell phones.
And was finally ready to reconnect with his family.
Anus tart is turning on Tracy Lane.
He's creeping up George Michael.
All right, guys, let's entrap a local predator. All right, who, what, when, where, why, and how?
Who, what, where, when, why, and how? Who, what, when, where?
Anus tart is approaching the border.
And Tobias's dream of finally getting to be in a TV show was finally coming true.
Is there a little girl here all by herself?
And perhaps it was this that would finally get him to admit that he sometimes did speak.
Daddy needs to get his rocks off.
In a misleading way.
Have some lemonade.
Pretty good lemonade, huh?
It is. Is there alcohol in here? John Beard.
Why are you here?
I'm here to see my little girl. I wanted to show her daddy's thing.
Oh, okay, so it's your daughter you're here to see.
Yes. Maybe.
Well, you're free to go. She's not here.
But this creep won't take go for an answer.
Oh, that's all right. I'll stay. Oh, wait.
And this creep makes himself right at home.
Give me just a minute.
He's not leaving.
He's not leaving.
He's not leaving.
Tell him there's a raccoon in the backyard.
Hey, guess what? There's a raccoon out on the patio.
Bullshit. Where is that little guy?
And this guy turns out to be a real comedian.
Oh, I just broke my skull in a fourth place.
I mean, it's just a little alcohol poisoning never killed anyone.
Actually, alcohol poisoning is responsible for over 4,000 deaths a year.
Binge drinking, not cool.
I mean, come on.
You can all go f*** yourselves. What?
Sure.
Please welcome the talented voices of Phineas and Ferb. Go f*** yourselves. You.
Can you imagine driving that car?
No, I can't, no. Get away! Sorry.
Get away, get away.
Hey, I met a girl today, and her name is...
With his father's rights in hand, Michael the producer went to show off in Hollywood, while George Sr., magazine in hand, went to off in an MRI machine.
No, you're not gonna find anything here. They've been abandoned for...
Lindsay. No, this, maybe Tobias?
It was John Beard.
Shall we?
Now the value of these homes is gonna go down if we don't sell one today.
Let's see if I can find a,
Do you have a bottle opener?
Is there a little girl here all by herself? Daddy needs to get his rocks.
We don't have to hear this again.
Michael expects me to sell these split-level death traps. No, I'm not supposed to do that. I mean, there are no schools or libraries or internet or playgrounds within 20 miles of here.
You know, it's funny. I've been looking for a place to live, and that fills virtually every parole requirement I have.
That's great. When can you move in?
Now. Oh, the other sex offenders are gonna be so jealous.
And that's when Job...
Wait a minute.
...went from filling one Sudden Valley house...
You know of other people with similar needs?
Oh, I have a list of men that could fill every opening you have.
To filling them all.
Let me get a shot of mustard. No, it's all cheese, but no mustard.
No, I think we just might want to slow down a little bit on the whole fake block thing, because I'm still not 100% finished with it.
Well, how finished are you with it? 200%? 500%?
Yeah, I also feel like I'm not 100% finished with your math tutoring.
I am going to go there with you for moral support. And I will act as your assistant. And maybe I'll do my famous gay character. I don't think you've seen that character.
I think I have.
I don't think so.
Michael's here. This is my chance to make sure he doesn't get too cozy with Job.
Why?
Bad things happen when brothers collude.
When can we have sex?
And he definitely thinks you're gay, right?
Don't worry. The only thing I'm better at than f***ing women is pretending I'm gay.
Listen, I gotta go shoot a PSA. I'll text you from the car.
Oh, no, don't do...
Action.
Tweet and drive.
Yeah, that was good, but it's text, and we need the word don't.
It's almost like maybe we shouldn't skip town after this next one.
Next one? Another paint bomb?
No, a real one. On Cinco de Cuatro, Love's boat is going to...
Cinco.
...go into the what? Yes, Cinco.
I know it's scary. I just got out of a long relationship, too. But I'm here for you.
And girl, I ain't going nowhere.
I need you to leave.
So let's get it up!
Wait, what's happening?
Buster was upset. And perhaps that's why he availed himself of the photos of Herbert and the prostitute he didn't realize was actually his sister. Before using the wrong hand to punch a picture of Herbert.
Stupid Buster!
Hi, Tobias VK, registered sex offender.
Lucille, too. I've been looking for you.
Buster! You look different. Something's happened to you.
Yes. I've been with a black woman.
I was talking about your hand.
Oh, this huge thing? Yeah, it's new.
Debris was also at a loss. Feeling frightened and fragile, she tried to keep it together.
Water.
Unfortunately, Debris, who had been in the safe harbor of a drug-free zone, found herself in the free drug zone of an unsafe harbor.
Oh, pardon the mess. I just blew myself for the first time in 5 years.
You hired Chinese?
Well, I figured who better than the Chinese to build a wall?
But no, I couldn't afford them, so I hired, they're technically Mongols. I guess they're the people that they built the wall to try to keep
out. How many did you hire?
A horde. That's the minimum. They don't come in anything less than a horde.
So you hired a Mongol horde?
Look, Dad, if they don't get their money soon, they're going to be really mad, and then they're going to have a major Mongolian beef with us. They're there.
Okay, we don't have any money.
Well, he says that we don't have any money.
There's no way a hot cup of coffee and a glass of the Show Must Go On spirit will encourage you in any way, will it?
Let me die.
No.
I want to go back to why you're all in here, though.
Oh, we're shooting footage for Lindsay.
Campaign footage.
And then Job had an idea.
What do you say, you and I?
A horrible idea.
F*** our way through Mexico.
Fitzy, hi, it's us again. Help! Did you redo the floors here? Help, we need a doctor. Oh, it's okay, she's usually on pain pills.
I'm gonna call it. Looks like she's been stiff for about 18 hours.
I won't tell Mom about all the ladies you're f***ing. If you don't tell Mom about all the ladies I'm f***ing.
Whoa. Look at that one coming up.
Where? Oh my God. Oh, she's hot. She's so hot, dibs.
No. Daddy saw her first. Daddy dibs.
She got a friend or... She's got a friend. That's a friend, right?
Bush. Cast again, Bush. Thought it was a woman.
Yeah. Like hunched over, yeah. Right? Like with the... I wanted to do her so bad.
Wow, I really liked her friend.
Me, I liked her too. You think that was like a 10-gallon hefty sack?
Yeah, 10. Definitely a 10.
The tinfoil's still here, but I'm super confused. Do we have magic gummy bears that just get up and walk away?
Yeah, one got up and walked right into my mouth. What are you gonna do about it?
So, we gotta wait about 48 hours before we declare you missing, and they put out an APB.
APB? Ah, poor Buster.
That's nice.
Hi, I'm Michael, and I came here to save everyone, so I feel special about myself, even though you don't deserve it, so I'm leaving and I won't be coming back.
Buster?
Oh, look who's back. I thought we were supposed to go with a f***er. Oh, you would know, Mother. You practically invented f***ing when you get sauced. How dare you point that limp hook at me when I saved you from one? I can't believe I pushed you out of my you useless jizzy freak!
You sound like you're having fun down there.
Oh, it takes a lot out of me, but they like to look at me as the sticky white glue that holds the family together. But now, you're my family. My biological son and my pathological girlfriend.
I hate everything about my life, including you.
Well, that's not the horniest thing I've ever heard.
Daddy, not horny.
Why are we hiding?
Yeah, I thought you said you were the sticky white glue that this family sniffs together.
That was me tap dancing on your grave, all right?
Yeah, I think I'm in the wrong place.
We're in a bad situation here. But I've been jammed with bigger things in tighter spots than this. Jammed two fingers. Voices up! Just three 56-year-old women looking for a place to rest our weary asses.
Oh, fuck.
So hold on, we've got $3 million tied up in something Job's in charge of.
Maybe we could just hire him like a really good assistant.
One step ahead of you.
I took this guy home with me last night after I found him next to the police station. Please, say hello to my new right-hand man. You beat.
Did somebody say I took this guy home with me after I found him next to the police station?
Well.
Now I just gotta figure out how to get rid of you guys.
Group hug! Group hug!
Hug! Hug! Hug! Debris. Group hug.
We break the stick and not the pinata, okay, look. Woo! Huh?
Well.
How long's it been?
It's been 5 years.
What are you doing here?
I'm taking my 5-year-old to see Fantastic Four.
I'm pretty sure that's an adult.
Wait, you have a 5-year-old?
And then his father's a magician.
Oh, it's not us.
Don't worry, it's not you. It was a real magician.
Now everybody's gay!
Our stay at the Spotted Palm came to a rather abrupt end when Bev here decided to look at her cellular telephone without holding it at arm's length and putting on her readers first.
She kind of blew her cover.
I'm sorry, I keep on forgetting that acting is my passion.
It really ruined Annette's funeral. May she rest in peace.
Chick, chick. Chick, oh. Chick, chick, chick.
It was an impression that not only cost him his last shirt...
Are you all right?
...but that he chose to keep to himself.
Well, I didn't chicken out. I mean, people even say I stole the show. You know, I'm thinking about doing like a solo show, maybe do some close-up magic, a little sleight of foot.
Entrap local predator there, 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 and there. We're gonna destroy Tony's career by proving that he's straight when he has sex with you while you're wearing... this Job mask. Oh, and this little black mini robe. Just to really sell that you're a man.
Why would I wear a Job mask?
Well, because Tony's coming here expecting to have sex with me. Look, in the act of having fake gay sex, you're gonna take off the mask to reveal that you're having real straight sex, destroying his career, and it's all gonna be captured on that camera right there. Main event is us having this pretend gay, but actually straight sex.
And you know what it is? It's a straight bait.
I just realized it's a straight bait.
You ever watch those?